Let's chop game one time. I'ma wait on y'all. Hold on, and tell me if my audio cool. Hold on for a minute.
Let's chop game.
Here we go. I sound cool right there. How I sound? Am I loud? Am I cool? Hold on for a minute. Let me know. Come on up in here, man. Yeah, let's chop it up. You've been waiting on it. You've been getting in my DM about it. You've been in my DM from AM to PM about it. Some of y'all done text me about it. Man, come on, man. I know it's pimping whole hours, man. I know it's 3:28 right now, EST time in this Mississauga, but so what? You know what I mean? Come on, man. You squares, get out to bed. Come on, I know you still got turkey and you still got the yams and, you know what I mean, all in you. You know, some of y'all still farting and things. I appreciate y'all patience, man. You know, I had to take care of a little something because, you know, when I go live, I really don't be wanting nobody, you know, dealing with. You nigga, you told me what? Talking about I told you sin. Nigga, what you tell me? Blessings to you, baby. How you doing? Niggas always talking about what they told me. Niggas, it's a bold statement. You told Sam. Nigga, what you tell me? What you tell me? You mean I told them? You mean I told everybody? Nigga, what you mean? Yeah, what? Y'all got to stop getting high and doing these drugs. What's going on with it, though, man? Talk to me. Told you that he wants you to run him some bread. Yeah, we're going to talk about that. Yeah, I told you from the beginning, man. Sharp gonna be a cold actor. Yeah, I see some great movies. I'ma speak that in his existence. I see some great movies in Sharp's future. I could see him, you know, getting some Academy Awards, some Oscars, man, for his acting. That was some beautiful acting last night. Shout out to Sharp, man. Cold actor, he's gonna be good. He's a natural. He didn't even have to go to a performing arts school either. On his channel, made the game look good. Yeah, you know, he came to my live the last time. So, you know, I wanted to come to his live, you know what I mean, and show a little love. But, you know, he got a little Hollywood on me. Yeah, he got a little Hollywood on me. And he shouldn't have did that. Because I'm the wrong one. And I know he got some teeth. But his teeth ain't like mine. Yeah, that little thing with him and Johnny Cash, that little go back and forth with Johnny Cash, that let me know he wasn't ready for me because he wasn't ready for Johnny. And most of the shit that Johnny was using was my shit. You know what I mean? And he couldn't even fuck with that little ass shit. You know what I mean? Because Johnny didn't even do it right. But we gonna talk about it. I don't have no hate or dislike for the man. I understand. He's in the spotlight. You know, I mean, that's what happens to a lot of guys. The spirit of the diva spirit, you know, comes over a lot of niggas. They get very Patti LaBelle-ish. You know what I mean? And, you know, they start just talking crazy. Now that she's, you stupid. You stupid for even remembering that. Shout out to you, though. But can my likes look like my viewers? We already got damn near 500 people up in here. But why is it 425 likes? I'm going to wait till y'all get the likes up. We'll just be here. Ralph, man, appreciate the 10. Y'all coming in here with the respect. I appreciate that. You know, and Sharp, I know you're going to be watching. I tried to tell you, but, you know, you had got a little Hollywood. But, you know, appoint you some mods, man. So the mods can tell the people to click on the subscribe and the bell button, to hit the like and to share the video and, you know, keep the things rolling for you over there, you know? But shout out to him. He tried. Man, if Sin do an impersonation of Sharp versus him crying. Listen, stop it. Stop it. You guys are too much, man. You too much. Snazzy girl, what's happening, baby? But you know what upset me the most, though? You know, not, of course, we're going to get on Lil Kelpie. We got a message for everybody tonight. But what really vexed my spirit the most, what was a vexation of my spirit the most, was there was just no accountability. And as the scripture says, to whom much is given, much is required. And I didn't hear no accountability last night from Sharp. No accountability. You know, accountability. He gave a little speech, a little half-baked after-school program speech to a little boy. But there was no accountability. You know, there was no accountability. You charmed and disarmed him. You conned him into coming up there. And then you totally act different. And I believe that because, of course, you know, you got it, me talking about, yeah, Sin, you know what I mean? Your channel is thriving and, you know what I mean? You're doing good, man. Man, keep doing your thing, loved one. And, you know, man, me and you should do some reactions. And you notice when you said, you know, that me and you should do some reactions, notice I never acknowledged that or never even responded to that, because I know the type of individual that Sharp is. Sharp wants a bunch of yes males around him, and I'm not that nigga. I've lost a lot of so-called friendships in the game with individuals simply because I stuck by what was right, the truth. Appreciate that, Five, Knight, appreciate that. You know what I mean? I stuck by the truth. And because I stuck by the truth of this game, you know, certain individuals had to drop by the wayside. And, you know, I know that me and him, and this is no disrespect, blessings to his endeavors, but I just know me and him, we wouldn't work out. Not at all. Not at all. Because the moment that he tried that Hollywood shit, or he even tried to, like, reprove or rebuke, it's going to get ugly. It's going to be the coldest verbal crucifixion of his existence. He's not even mentally prepared. He's not even mentally prepared, man. It would just be cold. So, again, I just want him to stay doing what he's doing. You know, he says he's the face. And I believe that. He is the face of the game right now. You know what I mean? When squares think of pimping or anything pertaining to pimping right now for this new generation, they do think of Sharp because he's mainly in their face. So I can agree with that. And that's why I'm saying, to whom much is given, much is required. You know, and I appreciate you guys for clicking on that like button, man. You know what I mean? Yeah. But I just want to play you something so you can understand where Sin is coming from. We be chopping it up like family. So y'all let me know, and you just say, Sin, you tripping. Okay, can we do it like that? I don't want no Hollywood shit. Can we just look at this like family sitting at the table? And I'm speaking to y'all, and if I say anything contrary to the truth, I want somebody to be like, Sin, that don't sound right. That's family, right? No Hollywood shit. We just chopping it up. There isn't anyone better to preach and teach on this game. Blessings to Sim. Man, blessings to you. Travis, what's happening? Malik, what's happening? Man, y'all coming in here with a whole bunch of ones beat a whole bunch of nuns any day. Man, appreciate that, Malik. Good looking, man. But look, let me say this. You know, when you call a man a bitch, because I seen everybody, Kelby did this and Kelby did that. But see, y'all looking at the fruit of the problem. And if we're going to attack the problem, you have to go to the root of the problem. What I said don't sound right. I don't know if you're on drugs right now. You're just speaking to be speaking. I haven't even spoken yet, loved one. But calm down. You know, I don't even know Sharp to you. What did that have to do with anything I just said? You know, just think before you talk. But again, if I say anything contrary to logic, if I say anything contrary to that which is right, let me know. I haven't even started yet, and you're talking about it don't sound right. Then when I looked at your statement, I'm like, okay, I only know him through you. What did that have to do with anything I just said? Now, I don't want you guys to be like women and just start talking. I expect the ladies to do that, to just speak out of emotion. Think before you speak, son. Now, getting back to this game that I never left, we have to go to the root of the problem. This boy was called a bitch in front of millions of people. Yes or no? Am I messing up? Was he called a bitch in front of millions of people? Hold on for a minute. Yes or no? Have I lied yet? Before we even get started, I just want to see if we get the first base together before it turns into a home run. Okay, so we can agree that he called him a bitch. Let's, matter of fact, let's watch that. Hold on for a minute.
Fuck out of here. My bitch. If she wants to leave, that's on her, but I'm not going to send her away.
Which one of them was your family member?
Family member? What
like
the fuck?
Like a stepsister.
I'm not related to either one of them. What the fuck? Fuck no.
I'm just, hey man, I'm just asking.
Touch all bases.
Why the hell?
I'm just trying to touch all bases.
No.
You
gotta
touch all bases. You didn't see,
no.
Look at the disrespect that was shown. Not only did you call the boy a bitch, but you're insinuating that he's involved in incestuous activities. And you niggas talk about disrespect. See, this is what I said. This is why intelligent minds have to come. After you listen to all the gangbangers and the strangers and the idiots that think they pimps, you know, you have to listen to somebody that has sense. These niggas just be talking. You insinuating that this boy is involved in incestuous activities in front of the world, then you proceed on to call him a bitch. Let's watch.
Like, for the record, like, y'all, none of them have any type
really
of family history, step sibling, cousin, any of that bullshit.
You sure, bro?
Second, third, 15th cousin, none
they
of that
say
shit.
One of them's your
none
cousin, because that's the only
no,
thing we smell
No, because we both have
you.
Brown hair and we look similar.
That's the
we're
only thing
mixed.
We smell on
that's
you.
All. We don't. We are not related in any way. Not even through marriage or legal bullshit, none of that. No. Fuck
we're
that.
Mixed.
What?
I was just stuck on the fact that you... ass nigga, and that you try to sit here and say, oh, I'm mixed. Like, I don't respect you, nigga.
You don't
whatever
have to.
You want to do, I'm just being honest. I don't respect your pip, and I don't respect none of that, homie, because you played
you
with the game.
To.
You don't know what this shit really came with, Kelpie. Take your ass home, nigga. Go home with your mom
your
and try
home.
To...
I agree with that, Kelpie. Go home. I've been saying that. Give your life to God, son, and go home. That lifestyle of criminality, carnality, reality is, it's not for you. You're not built for that. You know, but I have to be careful of me even saying that, because I think that by saying that, that intensifies your desire to want to even participate in things that you have no business participating in, you know. But again, son, this life, matter of fact, I'm going to call you by your name. Kenneth, this is not for you. This is not your life. You, as the scripture says, there is a way to seem it right unto a man, but the ends thereof is the ways of death. You might have think you just got so much time to be stupid. And son, you end up making some unwise decisions that end up being your last decision and cause you to accelerate to your expiration date before the appointed time, son. I'm telling you what the Lord loves, the truth. This ain't for you. You know, but let's proceed on. I just want to get confirmation of some information that I'm saying and conveying. Come on.
Relationships with her and your family and trying to do some other shit, homie. This is not for you. I'd rather you say, and you even told me, you was like, yeah, Sharp, I don't think this is for me. Because you even told me on the phone, that's all my kids. That's all my kids. You was like, yeah, I really don't think, I didn't think this through.
Not forever, you can't.
That's all my ism, nigga. Anything I ever stood for, nigga, this is what this boy told me. So for him to sit here and fucking lie, that's why I've been calling you. That's why I told you I suck the fuck out you, nigga.
I ain't lying about
I'm
shit,
not
though.
Playing with you. You've been lying, nigga.
I just told you.
What was the sense of saying that? But again, I understand that Sharp works for Mark. I mean, not Mark, but Adam. And by him being an employee of Adam, by him working for Adam, he has to generate views for Adam. And I must say that Sharp put on a great show on Adam's platform. So I understand why he did what he did. You know, as an employee at No Jumper, he has to put on a show. And he did that. But, you know, he appears to be winning. But as far as the game is concerned, And as far as, you know, because on one end, you know, a motherfucker preach to the youth and say, hey, man, you that ain't right. And woo, woo, woo. But look what you're doing to him in front of the world. But again, I understand that this is his job.
Been lying, boy. You've been lying.
I ain't been lying.
Nigga, forever to what? You never even touched it.
Touched what?
The game.
That part.
The game, my nigga.
I would never take that away. That is so, oh my God. If you're a rapper, you need to put that on your mixtape. When Sharp says the game, oh man, that is perfect for one of you little rappers getting to the studio and make a song. That's the perfect sample. The game. When the game. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? So yeah, that I can't take that away. That is very, very comical, and not just that. It just meant the game. You get that on there.
I've been in the game not as long as
no,
long,
you don't. You never shit. Played it. You can't even say that.
You've been wearing a pimp.
Matter of fact, I'm going to speak that into existence for Sharp. Hopefully, one day. You know how John Madden used to be the voice of ESPN. Of John Madden football, Sharp would be perfect for a football video game. Hopefully one day Sharp gets to be the voice of NBA Live. I don't know the new games. Y'all know the new games. I ain't played no video games since Jesus was crucified. I told you, you know, since Live 95 days. But I remember when John Madden, it's in the game. You know what I mean? See, I'm showing my age right now. I'm 38. You know, but remember when John Madden used to say that? It's in the game. Like, I could see Sharp doing the voices for, you know, John Madden video game or, you know, so I'm going to just speak that in his existence, man. Not just good movies, but video games as well, man. He just got the voice for it. Blessings to him.
For a few months. You really a bitch. Up here, imposter. You really are a bitch, my nigga.
So wait a minute. Hold on. Let's go back. I just wanted to play that before we get to the main event. Because we, in order to attack, hold on, I think this is a fake Kelby page. I ran game on Sharp No Jumper. They never seen it come. Whoever that is, man, blessings to you, man. I mean, hey, do your thing. But again, we have to go to the root of the problem, and the root of the problem, The boy was called a bitch by Almighty Suspect, and then Sharp just went with it like, yeah, you is a bitch. Like, what the fuck?
Because you even told me on the phone, that's all my kids. That's all my kids. You was like, yeah, I didn't think this through.
Not forever, you can't.
That's
all
my ism, nigga. Anything I ever stood for, nigga, this is what this boy told me. So for him to sit here and fucking lie, that's why I've been calling you. That's why I told you I suck the fuck out you, nigga.
I ain't lying about shit.
I'm not playing with you. You've been lying, nigga.
I just told you.
You've been lying, boy. You've been lying.
I ain't been lying.
Nigga, forever to what? You never even touched it.
Touched what?
The game.
That part.
The game, my nigga. Come on.
I've been in the game not as long as
you. No, you don't. You never played it. You can't even say that.
You've been wearing a pimp costume for a few months. You really a bitch.
A pimp imposter. You really are a bitch, my nigga.
You really are a bitch.
I wrote you, nigga. You was getting this.
Man, fuck.
You see how he fed off of all the whole video, they were disrespecting him, but it never got to the bitch word. Then Almighty Suspect calls him a bitch. Then Sharp proceeds on to call him a bitch. And then they got to be disrespectful. See, like he said, it was very necessary. No, calling him a bitch wasn't necessary. I don't give a fuck what he said. I knew it was unwise from the gate. Go to my last video. I said that while he was in the comment section. That wasn't called for. Yeah, you know what I mean? It was necessary. Nigga, calling him a bitch after your co-host and said it, and then you repeating it, that wasn't necessary. You could have chopped him without calling him a bitch. Because, see, I'm going to say this. It's a lot of motherfuckers that's professing pimping. That's just as goofy as Kelby is. But at the same time, you really think that if a motherfucker of size that knew how to get down, that was a hog, you understand me, from the shoulders, you really think the motherfuckers would have called him a bitch? No, it wouldn't have went that way. It only went that way because it was Kelby. Niggas is not like that. Niggas is sitting over there picking and choosing who the bully. Keep that shit all the way 100. Niggas is not like that. Niggas is picking and choosing who to bully. That's what I'm seeing. And so, you know what I mean? Just to keep that shit all the way, you know, 100, this was just unmanly. It was unwise. You know, you could chop somebody. You can criticize and minimize and verbally crucify without calling somebody a bitch. There was no need to call a boy a bitch in front of the whole world. And then for Sharp to give a lecture to him, an after school program speech, after that happened, and then take no accountability for what happened, I'm just looking like, I know somewhere within this video, he got to take some accountability. But he never did it. So, you know, the smallest gestures speak the loudest volumes about somebody's character. And last night it spoke concerning Sharp's character. He didn't take no accountability at all.
Yeah. Fuck you. Man, hey, we're about to get out of here. I don't give a fuck about what you're saying no more, nigga. Your little bitch ass been sitting here lying the whole time instead of saying, like, yeah, y'all niggas is right because I talk.
The way that he's even talking to him, this ain't even the way a pimp chop. Did you hear what I'm saying? This ain't even the way that a pimp chop. This sound like little gangbangers. This sound like little punks, you know what I mean, talking to each other. Man, this don't sound pimpish. I don't know who taught him how to chop, but this ain't it. Because I guarantee you, if them same words were spoken to certain men that are not pimps, but still are certain men, this shit would have been ugly. But because it was a kid, it was a child, it was a 19-year-old little boy, that's why that shit went on. You know. But let's see, let's continue this unpimpish video and we'll get to the main event. Come on.
To you, nigga, and you lying. And I'm tired of this shit. Like, I played a little shenanigans with you, okay? We kept it going, but you really been lying and I really been wanting to cut your fucking ass off, nigga, a minute ago.
And Kelby, you not off the hook because you do be lying. Kelby, you know, we gonna get into that, but Kelby, you be freestyle lying. And you not even good at it. I don't know who told you, Kelby, that you the cannabis or the jizzer of lying, but man, you need to cut that shit out. I don't know, since you want to know about this pimping so much, you know, when you the pimping, you got to be a man first. In other words, you got to be the truth. And nothing but lies be coming out your mouth. That's one of the innumerable reasons why you not this pimping, Kelby, because you be lying. And you not even good at it. You just be stepping up to the mic and you just be freestyle lying. You just be going in like you mixtape Wayne, you know what I mean, with the lying. And you gotta stop it. I'm like, damn, he didn't even sit down and really think about this lie, because if he would have thought about what he said on Soft White Underbelly, then if he would have thought about what he said here, and then on this interview, and then on this interview, and see, one thing about when you keep telling lies, especially individuals that's looking at your interviews, they're going to see them inconsistencies. They're going to see that there's some discord going on. Brother, stop freestyle lying. Kelby, one of the innumerable reasons why you are not the pimping is that you are a full-fledged 100% ordained liar. You are a liar. Stop lying. That's not manly. It's very feminine. And I know you be watching my videos because I can tell. I could tell by this new video that we about to see that you was watching my shit. So I know you're going to see this. Stop lying. It's not manly. It's not pimpish. Stop lying. Let's go.
Respect the game, nigga. I really came from this shit, and we don't fuck with you, nigga. You a sucker, nigga. You a straight sucker. You a disgrace, nigga. You a straight booger, nigga. You a booger under the table, some motherfucker wearing somebody's glass that got smeared. Shut up.
That's why niggas disrespect.
Why would I disrespect the game that's been helping me out? Why
would I? It never helped.
Why would I?
Look at you. All
the wrong things you tell me that would disrespect
the game. You can tell me with that. You can tell me that with a straight face that nigga, this game really helped you.
Your game, yes.
Not my game, nigga. The game. You made money.
Yes.
You fucking sucker.
It's helped me out.
You've lied. Wow. With a couple bucks?
A couple bucks?
I ain't trying to tell you to go get a couple dollars. That's a lot of money to you.
It's not a couple bucks.
It really is.
It's a couple racks.
Buddy.
But it's a good amount of money.
$500 is a couple bucks for you.
$500.
That's a lot for you. You've never seen it. You've never seen it. Your parents spent it on your Xbox last Christmas.
What did they pay for me? 18 bands? So $5? $500? Whatever?
No, nigga.
Not a lot of money.
You wrote that on the paper.
I wrote that on the paper.
You wrote that, sucker. You scum.
Wrote that on the paper.
You scum. I just wanted to ride with you for a second. I don't even fuck with you. You gonna bullshit me, I'm gonna bullshit you.
Nah, not, yeah,
you gonna bullshit me, I'm gonna bullshit
you.
You been bullshit, you been lying to me.
Now.
No, because you been lying to me, homie.
Been lying to you.
You lied to me from the beginning, and I don't fucking respect you.
Now you're lying.
Ow.
Because you just said I wrote that on the paper. They didn't really take that money from
me. I'm just saying. You gonna play with me? No, nigga, because you're a drug. No, you sold drugs. You sold drugs. And they probably took that shit from some of your family members. Nigga, you playing. I don't even respect it. I don't accept it, nigga. You need to get the fuck up out of our building, nigga. And that's how I call it. I don't respect it. Get your bum ass on.
Is that an invitation to leave for real?
Huh?
Is that an invitation?
That's an invitation for you to get the fuck up.
Peace out.
Chop suey. Take your headphones off, clown.
Nigga, get your bum ass on, Church. We ain't playing with you. Yeah, get your bitch ass on.
You looking when you take that lame ass jacket.
Get your bitch ass on. Get your bitch ass on. So again, this was not about chopping him. This was about views. It was about entertainment. It wasn't about getting to the young boy. It was about using him as a sacrificial lamb to grow your popularity and increase your currency as an employee at No Jumper. That's what that was about. You know, and I'm not mad at you. Do your thing. You know what I mean? You have a job to fulfill. Who am I to say anything judgmental about your job? But at the same particular time, don't give an after school program speech, you know, about, oh, I didn't want this to happen to you, Kelby. And, oh, I spoke to, you know, Almighty Suspect. And even he felt bad about, he didn't really even want to do that. Even though he's been posting, you know what I mean, Vlad, and he's been posting all the platforms that's posting it, and he's reposting it in his story. You know what I mean? And he's getting clouded up from it. But, man, he's been feeling the spirit of condemnation, and he's just been crying, man. And he just feels just so sad because of what happened to you, Kelby. Kelby. Like, come on, man. Don't get into your T.D. Jakes voice and be crying and shit. You know what I mean? Kelby, in the Potter's house, we was crying for you. We was mad that that happened to you. We was mad that you got your ass beat. Kill me. We cry out to God right now. Lord, hearken unto us. Lord, forgive us for what happened to Kelby's face. Lord, we didn't plan for him to get his ass beat like that. We didn't plan for him to have all them combinations and left and right, for him to get the Sugar Ray Robinson and Sugar Ray Leonard combination all at once. But oh my God, we beseech you, oh Father, on the behalf of our brother Kelby, like, knock that shit off, man. Knock that shit off. I'm like, who believed this? You know, who believed this, man? Hey, do me a favor. Get my likes up, man. Yeah, get the likes on One Accord with the viewers. You know, damn near, what is it, 914 people in here? But it's only 433 likes. Hit the like button. And if you like the content, click on the subscribe and the bell button. But all of this, oh my God, Brother Kelby. Like, nigga, shut up with all of that shit. Who believes this? All right, let's go to the main event. I just wanted to go to the root of the problem first, because everybody was, oh my God, how could he call Almighty Suspect a bitch? Almighty Suspect didn't call him a bitch. Like, the fuck? I'm like, damn, who's gonna keep it real? Hold on for a minute. Oh, by the way, this game is brought to you by the game. This game is brought to you, you know what I mean, by Fiji Water in this game. Hold on for a minute. There we go. Yeah, but we in this Mississauga. But yeah, this game is brought to you by Fiji Water, you know what I mean, and the game. And we in Mississauga, Canada right now. As you can see, Adam, this is Adam before he turned into a complete white man on us. At least he was a white man trying to be hip at this time. But as you can see, when the conflict came, that's one thing about them white people. When that bullshit happened, when that shit happens, they're going to become complete white on you. You're like, wait a minute, I thought you was down. I thought you was hip, man. You're going to turn into a complete white man on you. Adam had that look like, what the fuck? Oh, my God. Oh, you know, hold on. So let's get to it. Without any further ado, let's go.
Coolest podcast in the world. And today, pretty excited because we have somebody who's making a big splash on the scene.
Yes, sir.
Kelpie is in the
Little
building.
Little Kelpie, also known as Kelpie the P. A matter of fact, you can call me whatever you want. Just don't.
Okay, before Kelpie says this dumb little ass saying, you notice where, you know, everybody should notice by now. But look how Adam is protecting himself. Adam is like, I'm not sitting in the middle of this. Just in case if something do pop off. You have to be the dumbest motherfucker in the world if you didn't think that Adam knew that this had potential to do exactly what it's doing now. That shit is going on 2 million views within like 3 days, 2 or 3 days. You have to be stupid if you didn't think that Adam knew that this had the potential to do exactly what it's doing now. But Adam not sitting in the middle. No. Adam is sitting to the side. He's far away. Now, Adam's not a pimp. But what did I teach you about the white man and the Jewish man? What did I tell you about them? You know what I mean? In a business-like sense, you know what I mean? They're in a position, not they're not actual pimp, but they're in a position of power. And just like the pimping, hey, man, they don't be getting involved in no hoe shit. When you see hoes fighting, do you see pimps sitting over there trying to fuck up their manicure nails and get sweat mixed up with? Only time you're going to see a pimp getting into some a hoe fight is if his hoe getting his her ass beat. Like, damn, she beat my bitch up a little bit too bad. Let me stop this shit. This bitch fucking up all the markability. Like, oh, my God. No, hell no, bitch. You're not going to. Matter of fact, bam, stay away from my hoe. But other than that, pimps do not get involved in hoe shit. And what is Adam doing in a position of power? Sitting to the side, watching them go at it, getting paid? Boy, this is so easy. Appreciate that fact. Blessings to you. You know what I mean? Just sitting down, like, okay, now, what seems to be the problem with y'all?
Kelpie is in the
Little
building.
Little Kelpie, also known as Kelpie the P. A matter of fact, you can call me whatever you want, just don't call me broke.
So that's yeah, right.
Okay, Kelpie. Okay, listen. Since you be watching my videos, right? This is what I want to say to you, Little Kelpie. Stop saying that dumbass shit. I got to say it for the millionth time. Kelpie, stop saying that dumbass shit. Yeah, my name's Little Kelpie. And, you know, call me anything that you want, but just don't call me broke. What pisses me off, Kelpie, is that you think this is cute. You think this is cute. You know what I mean? You're like a thought that keep, you know how thoughts or bitches just be saying shit? And it's like, damn, how many times is this bitch going to keep saying this shit? How many times this broad going to keep saying this shit? How many times this child gonna keep saying it? You know how a child, a little baby, or a kid, or a woman just keep saying things, and you like, okay, I'm gonna go to another room, cause you either saying this to irritate me, or you just like, man, cause you just keep saying this, like, goddamn, be quiet. Why do you keep saying this, Kelpie? Who told you that this was fly? You know what I mean? Get him some. He don't need to see no Too Real for TV DVDs. Man, smack yourself. That's the problem now. That shit didn't produce nothing but some goofies and goofballs. But that's another story. But yeah, man, just keeping that shit all the way, you know what I mean, 100 with you, man. Stop saying that dumbass shit. Yeah, man, you know, it's a little Kelpie. Kelpie the P. Yeah, you know, for the record, because the album ain't long enough, you know. He probably about, I'm telling you, he's not going to say it on the interview because Almighty Suspect then said it, so everybody seen him say that. But I guarantee you, he going to end up saying it to a bitch. That you know, a square bitch or something. Yeah, the name's Kelpie, you know, for the album, because the record's not long enough, but you can call me anything that you want, but just don't call me broke. Lil Kelpie. Stop saying that stupid shit, Kelpie. It's corny. It's lame. Stop it. I know you can't help it. You just can't help it. That's just a little side of you. But please, just this, you know. Oh, God damn it. All right, let's get into this shit.
Kelpie, also known as Kelpie the P. A matter of fact, you can call me whatever you want, just don't call me broke.
So that's right.
Out here today.
And then co-hosting with me.
Big says Gerber displeasure, you know what I'm saying?
Another thing, people, I'm sorry. I know I probably told you guys in the beginning that this ain't gonna take long. But every time I see something, I just see something wrong. I can't help it. Get my likes to 600. You know what I mean? My likes should have already been at 1,000. We over 1,000 people in here. But you know what I mean? Get my likes up to 600. Everybody hit the like button. But I know, Kel, but you really thought that you was doing it. Because you got the fresh little Nikes on. You know what I mean? And you thought that you was doing it. But really what upsets me, Kelby, one thing about motherfuckers that's trying to be something that they ain't, they go overboard. And I want to see who going to catch it first. I'm just looking at the comment section. Ain't nobody said it, but I said, but look at the, like, notice that the nigga has on the P hat. Hold on.
Out here today.
And then co-host.
Why do you, like, Kelby, why are you wearing this P hat? Why are you wearing this P hat, Kelby? It kind of reminds me of, like, and you know, I want it to be like that. See, me, I'm not, like, sharp. I'm not trying to sugarcoat and give after-school program speeches for my dirt. Seeing you a hater, I know. But it's almost like a homosexual or a transsexual trying to be a woman. They always overdo it. They don't just want to be gang members of being gay. They want to be gang bangers. They want to be profuse gang bangers with the homosexuality. It's like, damn, like women are just doing it natural. And you motherfuckers are going over the top to try to act like a woman. You know what I mean? And this is how this shit look. Like, why do you have to have, like, well, you? Why did you wear this P hat? Why, Kelby? And see, what makes me feel bad is you put on this P hat in the mirror, and in your mind, you thought you was doing it. You thought that you was doing it, Kelby. That's what upsets me. That's what vexes my spirit as I just sit here and I just look at this shit. You actually put this P hat on in the mirror like, yeah, I'm going to kill him this time. Yeah, they got on my little fake jacket, but motherfucker, I got on this P hat. I got the matching shoes. I've been practicing all week. I'm Kelby the motherfucking pimp. Okay, hold on. Let me slide off the pimp. You know what I mean? I'm Kelby the motherfucking pimp. No. Hold on. I'm Kelby the motherfucking pimp. Oh, no. That was too high. I'm Kelby the motherfucking pimp. No. You know, I'm Kelby the motherfucking pimp. I know you've been practicing all week long how to say your name. I know it. I know you've been in the mirror with the P hat, moving your hands, you know what I mean? I don't know what you're talking about. You know what I mean? If you smell something false, then it got to be that cheap cologne that you're wearing. Nah, I didn't move my hand right. Okay, I seen the way Pimpin' Ken was moving his hands and Pimps Up Hoes Down when he said, let your next move be your best move. So hold on. Let me practice the hand gesture. Appreciate the fact. Good looking, bro. You know what I mean? Let me do that. Hold on. Yeah, man. You know what I mean? No, nigga, I'm into doing motherfucking cartwheels and flips. You know what I mean? Eating big chips. You know what I mean? Known to eat big dip. No. I didn't say the big dip right. I got to say dip. Known for eating the big dip with the chips. No. E-40 didn't say it like that. Damn, man. This pimp shit is hard. Okay, let me work on my church. Church. No. Damn. Fuck, man. I'm messing up. Church. Oh, my God, man. Oh, damn, man. Let me rewind. Okay, take it back. You guys are laughing, but on the real, just like a rapper or a singer, you know what I mean, works out in a studio and they be like, okay, take it from the top. Okay, again, like that's the same way that Dr. Dre had to help Eazy-E in the studio with the song in the movie. That's the way that somebody gonna have to help Kelby, you know what I mean, try to sound like some pimping. Okay, say it again. Yeah, bitch. Where's my motherfucking money, ho? I'm Kelby the motherfucking Pimp. Pimp. Okay, hold on. Say that again. Hold on. What's happening, peace? What's going on, peace? No, that's a little bit. Take it back. Okay, all right. Start over. Kelby the motherfucking Pimp. I walk with a limp. That's him. He been practicing in the mirror and he put this pee hat on. Kelby, you just going too far. You're going too far, Kelby. And then you got on the Arizona jeans from JCPenney's from back in the day. You know what I mean? With this motherfucking pee hat on. This is killing me, Kelby, but come on.
Me? Big says Gabriel Displeasure, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, Almighty for the album, because the record too short, you dig what I'm saying, though? The real deal, you know what I'm saying? Holyfield, you know what I'm saying? Not the impersonation.
Damn, he just came with a whole little monologue like OJ the Juice.
I must say, and this is no disrespect to Almighty Suspect, but I must say he is dressed a lot better than how he was dressed with Sharp. I mean, that was cool. I mean, maybe to some, but this attire looks a lot better. Shout out to him. Y'all go check out, you know, his music and things and, you know. But yeah, this looks a whole lot better. But hold back. So yeah, come on.
Okay, so I wanted to like hop in here and attempt to, you know, have a conversation that perhaps can build on some of the other conversations that have already happened.
Yeah.
So let's lay this all out. So you had a very, very viral appearance on Soft White Underbelly.
Yeah.
Tell me what happened. Like, what was your life like in the lead up to that? Why'd you decide to do that?
In the lead up to that, I was hustling. I don't want to say specifics, but I was doing
I saw that Mark allowed anybody and everybody to come on his platform. I saw that Mark allowed people to just come straight out of the garbage can and walk right in for an interview professing to be a pimp. And I said, damn, you know, if he'll allow people from Skid Row to just get out the garbage can and just walk right in and do an interview, surely he'll let me get one. So, you know, I got it, Mark. In his DM, I said, I'm a kid, you know, I'm a struggling rapper, but at the same time, I got two girlfriends that's willing to prostitute here and there. They don't prostitute every day, you know what I mean? Within the week, you know what I mean? Between each of them, they get $300 by the grace of God. But I think I'm good enough to be on your platform, and I think that we'll do views because, you know what I mean? I just got this Value City. Matter of fact, I can't even disrespect Value City. I got this gas station suit. And I can come on there, you know what I mean, with my Odyssey Fun World jewelry and my two girlfriends that's willing to prostitute from time to time, my weekend warriors. And, you know, I can just get on your platform and, man, you know, this would be good for my SoundCloud career and this would be good for your platform. Voila.
A little shit in the streets. And then basically I was like, you know
what? I
thought
like you've already filled this in about what you were doing.
Well, Sharp made some accusations about what I was doing. I don't want to admit or deny those, but okay. Yeah, basically I was getting money and shit. And then that hustle came to an abrupt end when I got raided. So then I switched into another one because I seen some people that needed help. And, you know, I just.
And I got on Kelpie's name, but I have to say that I do got to say this. These are two of the worst names. Now, y'all help me out. I'm 38 years old. I'm going on, you know, eternity with it. But, you know, help me out, man. Why would somebody call themselves Kelpie? Or why would somebody call themselves Almighty Suspect? Help me out. I'm slow. Help me out with that name. Why would somebody call themselves Almighty Suspect? Why? See, y'all scared to say it. I'm going to go ahead and say what everybody thinking. Man, both of these names is gay as hell. These names are very homosexual. Why is a motherfucker calling themselves Almighty Suspect? First of all, what is the Almighty about? I can see if you called yourself Mighty, but Almighty, you know, making yourself equal with the Almighty. But then Almighty Suspect, why that name? What compelled him to have that name? And this is no disrespect to him, you know what I mean? Because I heard he be outside. He get props for that. He's not lying. You know, I heard he do be outside. You know, he's not lying about it. He do be outside. He do be on blades. He do. But that name, though, Almighty Suspect, that name alone is convicted. It's not even suspect. It's convict. That is a convicted-ass name. What's your name, man? Yeah, Almighty Suspect. Like, that name, somebody right now explain to me so maybe I can get the understanding and say, you know what, my bad, I was tripping, I'm too old, I'm 38 years old, y'all a new era. But what does that mean, Almighty Suspect? Why would you call yourself a suspect? It's not even suspect, that is a convicted gay name. The name just sound gay as hell. You know what I mean? Kelpie, that's, come on, man. Kelpie sound like a new rice company. That sound like something for some new rice or something. You know, or a new cereal that only white people eat. What the fuck, what the fuck you gonna call yourself? That sound like a new motherfucking disease that it came out for the LGBT community exclusively. What the fuck you calling yourself that for? Yeah, man, you heard what happened to the homie? What? Heard he got that Kelpie. Oh man, you know, I heard only homosexuals get that Kelpie. Like, come on, man. What's up with these names? As much energy as y'all had going back and forth, why y'all didn't take half that energy to sit down and come up with a new motherfucking name? God damn.
In the game.
Describe getting raided, though.
Oh, well, I was outside vaping.
Oh my God, I'm tired of you saying this. And I hope you know, when you be saying this type of, I was outside vaping and shit, this sounds very thottish. I don't know, Kelpie, I'm helping you out. This sounds very thottish. I'm saying this to help you out. Seriously, don't say this, no. Don't say Kelpie no more. Don't say, you know what I'm saying? You know, you can call me anything, but just don't call me broke. Don't say that no more. And don't say, yeah, man, I just be vaping. You know, it sounds very thottish. It does. It sounds very thottish. And I got to help you out because the scripture says foolishness is bound in the heart of a child. You have to stop that. This is thottish behavior for a young male to be saying, yeah, I was outside vaping. What the fuck? You're vaping? See, that's why I can't deal with y'all today. This new generation, y'all be saying a lot of gay shit like girl boom. You got guys that saying girl boom. You got guys bragging about being petty now. You got guys calling themselves Petty LaBelle. What's another thing that y'all be doing now? I'm not, no shade. No shade. You niggas be shading. You niggas be period poo. You niggas be having a period poo pair. Yeah, and I'm going to be 100 with you, Kev. When you say that you vaping, that sound like you got on some jogging pants that got period poo on the booty part. Don't say you vaping no more. I'm here to tell you, don't say that you vaping no more. A man talking about he vaping, that sound like he got on a tight ass jogging pants, and on the booty part, it say period poo. Don't say you vaping no more. That sounds very hoish, young man.
You know, still hustling, and the girls were inside, and basically just got a no-knock raid. They came in, they pulled me outside, some undercovers, and they, like, drew their guns on me and shit like that, put me in the squad car.
This whole story is a goddamn lie. And, you know, it just sounds like when a child comes in and you say, what happened? They just start freestyle lying. Kelby, stop. You're lying. You're lying, Kelby. Just be yourself, Kelby. You don't got to try to act like no pimp. None of that. Stop it, Kelby. These are lies. You didn't get raided. None of this happened. You got locked up. You know, you caused some charges, but all this, yeah, you know, I got raped. Trying to make yourself like you that dude. Yeah, they took 18 bands off me. And I know you thought that once you got locked up, you're like, man, what you in here for? Yeah, man, they took 18 bands off me. Oh, my God. Foolishness is bound in the heart of a child. Come on.
And then they all just were, like, inside my house and like, yo, we got a warrant to search your person and your vehicle and your house.
But they were suspicious of you.
Yeah, they were trying to say that I was, like, you know, drug dealing or something like that.
Okay. And well, you don't have a case as a result of this?
Nah, I never heard back from them, honestly. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. And so then you decide.
That whole story don't sound right, Kelby. It doesn't sound right, Kelby. And I want to say something, but it's like, no, I'm not going to put that jacket on you. But Kelby, I'm just going to be 100. The reason why, son, that you have to stop participating or talking this street shit, because one thing I know about Satan, if you keep knocking on his door, he will open it for you. And son, I can tell you that you're not ready. See, I could talk this because this is in your time. It's just like with 6ix9ine, right? When 6ix9ine was making songs and dissing everybody and calling everybody a bitch, when he was disrespecting everybody's city and making songs, everybody thought he was just so cool. He was so clouded up. He was so popular. All his songs was like, it was popping. It was on the charts. Some of that shit was bought for, but we get into that later. But he was clouded up. He had all that street shit coming out of his mouth until a real street problem came. See, he just wanted to reap the benefits, you know, of the streets. But once the Eurocladon came, once them situations came, once the storm came, them the Nabis clouds came, oh yeah, he wasn't able to stand. As New Edition said, can you stand the rain? He wasn't able to stand the rain. He started testifying better than Sister Anderson on Wednesday night Bible study at Church of God in Christ. He testified better damn near than Sammy the Bull, almost. So just to keep that shit all the way 100 with you, Kelby, I'm not trying to put no jacket on you, but son, I can see that you're not ready. If you was faced with a situation that knocked on your door, you're going to break, son. Don't even put yourself in that circumstance. Because you won't be able to protect yourself like 6ix9ine is. He still got money. He's still making money overseas. He can still buy, you know what I mean, security, the best security. You can't do that. You're going to put yourself in a cold situation, and you're not going to be able to afford no security. And some problems is going to come your way. But right now, you can sit up there, you know what I mean, and let all of this shit go. you know, and stop promoting yourself as a pimp. Because you and I both know you're not that. You know that. You smarter than what people think you are. You know you ain't no pimp. Come on.
How did the Software Underbelly opportunity even come about?
Well, I've been trying to do some, like, online stuff and just get that internet money and also promote my girl's OnlyFans.
Okay.
So basically, check out Crystal Roses on OnlyFans, by the way. She's going up. But not basically.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We got to take that from Kelby. Appreciate, hold on, who is that? Appreciate my boy Ben Corleone, man. Bless us to the game. Appreciate the 10. Oh, my God. We got to take that. We got to take that from Kelby. Shout out to my Patreon. It's going up. Shout out to my pimping. It's going up. Shout out to the homie, man. He's going up. Like, Kelby, you just stop it, man. And if you go see his bitch on Instagram, by the way, I seen your bitch, Kelby. And I see, now they gonna make jokes about her. But them little pictures that I seen on IG, I'm not gonna lie. She does look like trash on in that. And I know you're gonna feel some type of way because that's your girlfriend. That just so happened to be doing you favors, right? But Kelby, she does. She looks like trash. She's dressed like trash. But at the same time, I can see the potential. I can see the potential. I can see some potential in the bitch, you know? I can see that, you know? She's a fixer-upper, as we used to say. You know what I mean? She's a fixer-upper. Under the right guidance and leadership, she can be molded into something. You know, she has some characteristics about her that just might be good for something. You know, time will show what that something is. But as of right now, I can just tell by her pictures on Instagram, Kelby, that her OnlyFans is not moving like that. You're not making any money off of OnlyFans, Kelby. Now, when you shouted her name off, you might have got a few little, you know, you may have made a few little coins here and there, a few little pennies. But realistically, you know, just after even seeing her, I didn't even have to go to her OnlyFans to see if there was anything going on. Just looking at the pictures that were shown on her IG page, Kelby, I can tell that you don't take care of her. The money that you profess, see, this is where the game comes in. You know, this is what they should have told you. Kelby, right now, you're making yourself look bad. Because here you're saying that you're pimping and you're saying that she's a hoe and Kelby, she looks like trash. She's dressed like trash. She looks like the best definition of cheap. She looks like she'll do a $40 date, Kelby. Just to keep it real, if it goes a little bit too long and she hasn't called anything, or if somebody was to catch her at a gas station or something, I really think your bitch would go for 30 bucks. Matter of fact, fuck it, I'm doing too much with this 30 bucks. Your bitch will sit up there and give the booty up just to get high. She's trash, Kelby. Currently, right now, that bitch is trash. And she's dressed like trash. And you know what we say in the game about bitches that look like trash, right? We say that the woman is a reflection of the man that she's with. So if that bitch look like trash, if she look a goddamn fool, it's because she's involved with a fool. She's involved with trash. A woman can only produce what she's introduced to. And you've been introducing that bitch to trash, Kelby. She looks like trash. And I can see the spirit of depression manifesting from her face. You know, Kelby, let that girl, you know, you really need to let that girl go back to her parents or recommend Jesus Christ or Yahshua, you know, Yaharisha, you know, whatever, Allah, who, you need to find her something. She needs to get involved in something other than what you're, because if she stay involved with you, with what you're doing now and evolving that, She's gonna be another. I forgot that little bitch on Soft White Underbelly. She's gonna be one of them old bitter bitches, and all the women gonna be like, "Oh my God, she was cuter back in the day." Seriously, Kelby, she looks like trash. See, this is a chopping. See how I haven't called him a bitch. I'm just saying that his bitch looks like trash. I can tell that you keep saying that, oh, this money in my pocket. I can look at your bitch and tell that you're not getting no money. I can see the way that your bitch is dressed that you're not getting no money. You're not getting no money, Kelby. You don't even know how to dress a hoe. You don't even know how to motivate a hoe. You don't know how to educate a hoe. You don't know how to pick a hoe up when she's down. You don't know what to tell a hoe after she got raped. You see, you never been through these street circumstances, son, because you never been in the streets. You one of these guys that found you a girlfriend willing to do something on the internet from time to time. But Kelby, stop this mess. Stop this foolishness. As a matter of fact, you know what I mean? I might even bring that up later. Let me just let this video, because I'm ready to kind of go in on you already, and I ain't even got halfway through this video. Let's listen some more. Come on.
Get that internet money and also promote my girl's OnlyFans.
Okay.
So basically, check out Crystal Roses on OnlyFans, by the way. She's going up. Basically, I was just trying to promote that stuff. So I went on Soft White, talking about my story. And then, yeah, that just kind of blew up from there.
So what was the feedback like? Like, what would you describe as the most common comments that you saw in response to the Soft White Underbelly thing that were really driving it being viral?
Oh, just a lot of hateful shit about the way I was.
Just like Kelby said, her OnlyFans is going up. I want my likes to go up. We damn near got 1,200 people up in here, but it's only 616 likes. Get my likes all the way up. Everybody click on the like button. It's the thumbs up button. I appreciate every financial contribution, but the biggest contribution that you can give to me is helping me get the notifications out and also getting these recommendations for the video. So by all means, man, click on the thumbs up button. Blessings to everybody. Let's go.
Mostly. People was like, and also I feel like they took a lot of the shit I said out of context. Like when I said I was homeless, that was because I just got evicted after the raid. The apartments had like kicked us out with some Section 8 that I was staying in with my family.
Oh my God. I'm really trying. I know y'all like, damn, saying you hitting the pause every 5-10 seconds. I know, because it's vexing to hear him talk. And let me say this to the youth right now. I noticed a lot of you guys, I noticed this. The internet makes everybody feel like they have a message. The internet has made everybody with a live button feel like they should be talking. And son, you don't have a message. Therefore, you're not a messenger. You don't have the game. So why are you speaking on the game? You're repeating somebody else's experiences, their talking points. You're taking from other people's intellectual property. Son, shut up. Speak in the vernacular of silence. Be quiet. Be swift to hear and slow to speak. Allow the game to speak to you. If you professing, even though we know that you're not this pimping, but if you're saying that you some pimping, then do what every young pimp does when they first get into the game. Be a sponge. Shut the fuck up. Be quiet. When other knowledgeable individuals are talking, be quiet. If you know that your only game that you're getting right now is through the fucking internet, then it would be best for you to shut the fuck up, because people on the internet that watch the internet can tell when somebody else is just repeating somebody else's talking points or their experiences. We knew right away the moment you started talking that you was looking at Sharp's interviews. You looked at other people's shit, but it was mainly, you know, you gravitated to Sharp and you took his talking points, you took his testimony and you converted it and tried to, you know, do your own thing with it. See, that didn't work too well for you. But come on, son, knock it off, you know.
And the girls, so they kicked us out of that. And then a lot of people were like, oh, why is he dressed like a Party City pimp, fake chains and all that. But you know, it's all real.
Fake people wear fake things. When you were wearing all of that shit, it was a representation of you. Enough said.
The outfit, I feel like that's the most thing that people said was being disrespectful, but I was just doing that to get attention. But all my jewelry is legit and stuff.
So, been diamond tested. Suspect, fill me in on that. Like, is there something expected of you before you've earned the stripes to wear?
So you say you've been diamond tested, but no, you haven't. So you haven't been diamond tested with the real jewelry. You haven't been soul tested. You haven't been spirit tested. You haven't been heart tested. P, how you get tested with that? You got to go to the streets. YouTube can't give it to you. Instagram can't give it to you. Snapchat can't give it to you. You got to go to the bricks. You got to go to the concrete for them experiences. See, one thing I know with the internet dudes and the strip club dudes and the digital pivot dudes, all of them dudes, right? Let's say if those guys become financially successful, once they come into contact with individuals who have experiences on the concrete, you know what I mean, year in and year out, especially cross country, and they start getting into them choppings and, you know what I mean, or any type of conversation, notice that them street, them concrete dudes gonna always run circles around them individuals, even if they rich. They gonna always make them guys on the other side appear to be small. Because you know why? They never been through nothing. That's why when they get into choppings and shit, they get ate the fuck up because they never experienced that. They were never outside. You know what I mean? They was hiding. They was like, they were the Harriet Tubmans of the game. They was creating underground railroads for hoes. They was hiding hoes from the pimping. You know, the pimping never had the opportunity to give her all you can hear buffet in the eardrums of these motherfucking hoes and shit. They hoes never got a chance to be sweated. Because if he put that crystal bitch down on a real blade, I got some young pimps right now that really got something to say to that young bitch. He gonna be missing a girlfriend. I'm telling you that right now. If he put Lil Crystal down right now, I got some young pimps that's gonna cheer her motherfucker. They gonna sit up there and chew her motherfucking ear off with this game. She's gonna make a decision. She's gonna have a new religion called pimping and hoeing. You understand me? After my little young partners sit up there and get, he's gonna get, matter of fact, I'm going to have to even say, come on, man, give him a call. Give him a, nah, P, I ain't giving him no call. He ain't no pimp. I'm not serving no white boy saying you tripping. I can see it now. You know what I'm saying? Come on, man, give Lil Kelby a call, man. You see he over there crying about his woman, man. He don't know whether the bitch dead or not. You know what I mean? He calling all around, man. Give Lil Kelby a call, man. Let him know that his girlfriend ain't dead. All right, P, I can see it now. If he put his little girlfriend down on the motherfucking concrete, nigga, oh my God, don't let him go to the Bay Area. Don't let them little young Macs, them little young players, and the few young pimps, you understand, straight up and down, you understand me, young little few pimps that the Bay Area have to sit up there, you understand me, and sweat that motherfucking bitch, she's going to come up missing. If he don't got it in him to put the bitch on the platter like it don't matter and let pimps really sit up there and get at the bitch like that. He don't have it in him. He's going to hide the bitch. That's why these guys be hiding the bitch, you understand me, in hotels and all that type of shit, eating pussy and trying to create underground railroads and shit for these hoes and shit. Y'all motherfuckers seen Rosewood when all them white guys had showed up. They was like, we know you got that nigger in there. Come on, where's Jesse? Where is he at? I'm told he's not here. He's not here. That's just how these niggas would hide these motherfuckers. That's just like Kelby and the rest of these fake niggas would hide the hoes. Pimpin' showing up like, man, come on, man, where the bitch at? Where the bitch at? Where Lil Crystal at, man? Where the bitch at, man? We got something to say to that bitch right now. She's not here, man. She gone. She not here, man. We ain't trying to hear that, Lil Kelpie. Where's the little bitch? Where your wife at? Where your future wife to be, man? We got something to say to the bitch. He created a whole underground railroad for the bitch to hide the bitch from the pimping, man. These motherfuckers be omnipresent to pee, man. You know what I mean? Hiding the bitch from the pimping, man. Like I said, he don't even know. He can't even call Lil Crystal a hoe because Lil Crystal ain't never been sweated. Lil Crystal ain't never had no real motherfucking masterpiece, mouthpiece pimps really speaking fluently and eloquently about this motherfucking game in her motherfucking eardrums and shit. You understand me? Because that bitch gonna sit up there, she's like, damn, Kelby don't talk like this. What is this language? What is this heavily language that I'm listening to right now? God damn. My soul is gravitating to this shit. Yeah, bitch. It's called this pimping. You know, he ain't never had that shit like that. Kelby smart. He know not to put Lil Crystal down on the blade. That bitch gonna come up missing, man. Plus, that's his only girlfriend right now. Man, please.
Certain types of, like, pimp outfits?
Nah, it wasn't even that. It was like, we felt like that shit, like, the equivalent for to get everybody to understand, kind of like blackface.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that shit was kind of like it looked like a costume.
Stealing from a culture, pretending to be something that you're not, putting on the costume. You know, I understand exactly what he was trying to say. Yeah, I get it.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's like, He came in here wearing that shit like in his hand, like.
What you mean you don't understand the costume? You got on the costume right now. You got on the motherfucking gas station pee hat on with the little matching Nikes. You know what I mean? You look foolish, Kelby. This is your so-called little pimp costume. And Kelby, you keep wearing this Chinese food, buy two egg foo youngs, one large shrimp fried rice, and get a free chain. You know what I mean? For free type of jewelry, son. That is not going to get you into this pimping, Kelby. Kelby think just because he got one of them, yes, if you buy one pepper steak, no black bean, two shrimp fried rice, and get a fortune cookie, we'll give you this ring and these two earrings, you know what I mean, right here. He think that's going to get him into this pimping. Like, yeah, man, you know what I mean? They diamond tested my shit. I'm ready. He one of them goofies that, like, yeah, man, I seen American Pimp. I finally bought me a pair of gators, man. I'm in. Like, no, goofball. You trying to be something that you're not. You trying to put on a cop. See, when pimp dress, it's his attire. It's his uniform. When you wear, it's a costume. You know what I mean? You look like Halloween. Come on.
This is what pimps is supposed to look like. I got my little dollar sign chain, my little fur coat.
I got two of them.
But do you feel like, you know, you could have rocked the same fit or something similar?
But I mean, I'm true to this, so of course I could. But that's the same thing. Though. Like, I'm black. Blackface. You get what I'm saying? Like, okay. It's like wearing blackface.
But so aren't there white pimps at these pimp conventions and
white
shit?
White folks is a popping ass white pimp.
And you didn't even know who he was.
See, Kelby. And shout out to Lil Kelby. Because Lil Kelby had made up in his mind. He said, man, they call me all type of bitches. They had me involved in all type of incestuous activities. You know what I mean? That last video, man, I'm interrupting this nigga. I'm talking over him while he's speaking. If it come down to it, I'm going to call him a bitch. You know what I mean? I watch, you know what I mean, all of these people videos. And I already know them comments ate you up. That's what really did it. That's what really did. You know how when you go to some comment sections, it say 13,000 comments, 20,000 comments. I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't be motherfucking surprised, Kelby, if you read all 20,000 comments. And after reading every comment on that motherfucking no jumper about you, you was fed up to your soul. You was ready to shoot something. You was ready to kill something and let something die. The way them people talked about you in them comment section, them review videos, the shit that I said, I know you was ready to beat somebody up. You know, and I'm going to say this, you know, people sitting over here crying and all of this shit, you know what, I'm going to wait till that happen. Let's go.
Until right now,
but
until
I know who
interview.
He is. I know
we
who he is.
We asked you that last interview, you had no clue.
You did not.
And Kelby, let me say this to you. Sharp and them not going to tell you. They not going to tell you, you know. And I know Sharp brought up the little teary-ass story, like, man, I used to talk to white folks, and I know Don and all of them was cool with them and everything. But see, I'm not a part of the church, Kelby. Neither am I trying to. I respect different individuals within it, you know, but I'm from Chicago, but when Sinful the P name come up, it's just by myself. It's not no organization, no, I'm not a part of no families and none of that. I'm just a name by myself, Kelby. And this is the thing, Kelby. Another reason why you not this pimping, I know they scared to tell you. And there's some people because they have white friends and Latino friends and shit in the game. But I'm going to be the first motherfucker to kick the door down and tell you, white boy, you are not this pimping. There is no such thing as a white man pimp. There is no such thing as a white boy pimp. See, you know, they can't talk like that because a lot of them, they mixed and, you know, they feel some type of way, you know, saying this, you know. But see, I come from the tribe of Pimpahola. I come from the tribe, you know what I mean, of nigga. I come from the tribe of pimp. And you're not a part of this tribe, son. All of these nice-ass niggas allowing all of these white people and these foreigners, you know what I mean, to be a part of this shit, you know what I mean, that's on them. But Kelby, ain't no such thing as no white boy pimp, Kelby. I know when they told you about white folks, you felt like, you know what I mean, that you had hope. And I'm going to tell you the truth about that too, Kelby. You know what I mean? I didn't think shit about white folks either. Even when I was a kid, when I seen white folks and pimps up, hose down, I thought he was a clown too, Kelby, just like you. Only thing is, I thought he was an elderly clown. See, you in your youth, so you got hope. You can change and get out of that little false frame of mind. But when I seen white folks on Pimps Up, Hoes Down, every time he would speak, I would just get vexed in my soul. And even when I seen him around Gangsta Brown in one little video, he looked uncomfortable. All you little white guys look uncomfortable, man, when you get next to this motherfucking real pimping, man. Real talk. So, you know, them other guys, they gonna sugarcoat shit with you and, you know, tell you, man, you know, the original white folks and, you know, you got white folks. And I know you got happy when you heard it, like, oh, so there is a white pimp. No, he was a clown, Kelby. White folks was a clown. And he was not this pimping. And I know I'm gonna get some phone calls later on. I do not give a fuck. I always thought white folks was a clown. I never thought he was this pimping. Even when before I even got into this pimping, as a child, I knew that he wasn't this pimping. And the game sent me here today to let you know, just like he was a clown, you a clown too. You not this pimping either. Just like he wasn't this pimping. Proceed, no.
White folks is a popping ass white pimp.
And you didn't even know who he was until right now.
But
until
I know who he is. I know who
he is. We asked you that last interview, you had no clue.
You didn't ask me about no white pimps last time?
The nigga Sharp said, you know who the fuck white folks is? You was like, no, I don't. You didn't know who the fuck that was?
He told me who that was on FaceTime before the interview.
Exactly. You didn't know who white folks was until we informed you.
Until Sharp informed me on a FaceTime before this interview.
Until a pimp informed you who white... Exactly.
But you know what I'm saying? There's white pimps out there.
Until somebody informed
So I don't get how it's blackface. That seems like you're bringing up racism where it doesn't need to be.
No. That was just a,
And then, hold on, I want you to go back. He's so lost in the sauce, he don't even know white folks is dead. Watch that. He said, I bet he's doing better than you. He was just so happy to hear that it was a so-called white pimp that was in this game. He got so happy, ready to speak in tongues about the shit. He don't even know white folks is dead.
That's white pimp.
And you didn't even know who he was until right now.
See, watch this. I bet you he's doing better than you. He don't even know white folks is dead.
The same thing. Like, I'm black. Blackface. You get what I'm saying? Like, it's like wearing blackface.
But aren't there white pimps at these pimp conventions and shit?
White folks is a popping ass white pimp.
And you didn't even know who he was until right now.
But I know who he is. Kelby, shut up. Shut up, Kelby. Listen to me, and listen to me good, son. You got something that money can't buy right now, and it's called youth. Don't waste your youth on something that you're incapable of being. You know what I'm saying? You're incapable of being this. Stop it. Just like, just put it to you this way. It's almost like this is why I get so angry at even my people, because they're so weak-minded, even in the game. Because you have certain plateaus, dimensions, that because of the color of your skin, because of you being a nigga, you know what I mean, that certain individuals, you know, refuse to allow you to reach. Why? Because they don't think a nigga deserves to be here. He don't deserve to be here with us. And the same mentality that they got towards my people and their walk of life on those dimensions, that's the same mentality that I have towards them and anybody outside of the black man concerning my lifestyle. And let me say this, you bitches look stupid as a motherfucker. You know what I mean? After your ancestors going through all that motherfucking slavery, and here come your dumb ass sitting over there actually believing that the white man, you know what I mean, could be this pimping. Bitch, slap your motherfucking self and die two times and come back and die again if you actually believe that dumb ass shit.
We asked you that last interview, you had no clue.
You didn't ask me about no white pimps last time?
The nigga Sharp said, you know who the fuck white folks is? You was like,
no, I don't.
You didn't know who the fuck that was?
He told me who that was on FaceTime before the interview
exactly.
Happened.
You didn't know who white folks was until we informed you.
Until Sharp informed me on a FaceTime before this interview.
Until a pimp informed you who white... Exactly.
But you know what I'm saying? There's white pimps out there.
Until somebody informed you before this interview.
So I don't get how it's blackface. That seems like you're bringing up racism where it doesn't need to be brought up.
No. That was just a...
Man. And all of that, we are the world. We are the world. We are the children. Nigga, no. Ain't no we are the world. Ain't no they don't really care about it. Ain't none of that shit going on in this pimping. This ain't the We Are the World Foundation in the pimping. This ain't me joining hands with the white man, with the Mexican, with the pedestrian, and all of them. You understand me about this pimping, man. It started with the black man. It was in the middle with the black man. It will end with the black man.
It's an analogy to get everybody to understand. I'm not saying that you were doing.
You said I was doing blackface.
To get everybody to understand, yeah, because you pulled up in a pimp costume.
They were saying it was like blackface, but is it the fact that he's white in general, or is the fact that he's so new in the game?
It's just because he's not really doing that shit in his head. He came,
but I ain't really doing that shit. My pockets will prove that.
That's like what's it?
Man, you got on a motherfucking gas station hat with some little $100-ass little shoes, and you gonna tell this man that your pockets approve that? Kelby, man, you gotta quit with the... I feel like Eddie Murphy and Nutty Professor, man. You go too far with the comedy, man. You came to No Jumper with your mama. Your mama drove you to No Jumper thinking that you was going on a job interview, because that's what you told your mama. I said it the last time, I believed it the last time, and I still believe it today. You told your mama that No Jumper was a new name for FedEx. Your mama thought that you was going in there on a job interview. She didn't know that you was going to be in there talking about being no damn pimp, Kelby. That's what your mama did not. Your mama didn't drive you there for that mess. I sound just like the mothers, too, for that mess. You know what I mean? You ought to feel ashamed of yourself. Yo, here go your mama thinking that she's sitting over there doing a good cause, helping her baby get a good job, and you gonna disrespect your mama, you know what I mean, with that bullshit, Kelby. Kelby, you need your ass beat. You need your ass beat. You know what I mean? Your mama's friend called, what's going on? Oh, I'm just sitting outside in the parking lot. Kelby's in there filling out his job application. He's in there, you know, getting an interview. Oh my God, I hope he's able to get a job this time. You know, I think Kelby will be good. They need to just give him a chance. You deceived your mama into thinking that you was going on a job interview, Kelby. Your mama did not know you was gonna be in here talking about this pimp mess. You know what I mean? And here you come coming in there talking about my pockets can prove this. Kelby, stop.
The fact that he's so new in the game.
It's just because he's not really doing that shit in his head. He came.
But I ain't
like,
really doing that shit. My pockets like, will prove came. That.
That's like, what's a good analogy? Well, I just gave one, like blackface, but let's do another one. Like a nigga who go to the gym with all this shit and he looking like he finna ball the fuck up. You feel me? And then when he get the ball, he can't do shit. But he came in his head like, this what ballers look like. I'm gonna get the headband, the socks, and all that shit. You get what I'm saying? Like,
what if he starts learning how to...
Anybody that's ever played basketball before knows what he's talking about. No, seriously, there's no King difference. How many times have you ever been to the court and nigga had on the fresh Jordans? I mean, he had the whole get up. You just knew when he got on the court that he was just getting ready to cross over everybody. That was not a bad example. No, it was not. No, that wasn't a bad example. I know what he was saying. Y'all be trying to act. Just because y'all don't like somebody. When y'all don't like somebody, y'all be like, nah, stupid example. Dumb. But if you play ball, you know what I'm saying. You just knew when one individual came to the court, he just had the whole get up. He had on the AI jersey. He had on the band. You was like, oh, he about to hoop. Okay, yeah, I'm going to have to guard him. I'm going to have to guard him because this nigga getting ready to bring it. He getting ready to bring it. I could already tell he got his game face on. Then when we get into the game, man, he missing layups. He airballing. You know what I mean? He don't have no handles. Come on now. You know, that was a good. You're letting the appearance be an interference. He's somebody. In other words, Kelby is showing up thinking that he's coming in pimp attire because he's really not. But he got the P hat on. He got the little Odyssey Fun World jewelry. He got his favorite punchlines from Sharp videos. And he's just getting ready to just pop it. And no, he's not the pimping. Come on.
Balled, and then he starts balling harder than other motherfuckers. Right? Is he still impersonating at that point?
Everybody's a little kid trying to beat like Michael Jordan at one point, right? And then right? The next day, boom, you are Michael Jordan.
You got to crawl before you can walk, bro.
I heard Sharp say this last night, and I'm going to have to agree with him. We ain't had a Michael Jordan since Michael Jordan. But Adam, I see what you was trying to say. You know, people fantasize about, you know, being that guy. And no, LeBron is not Michael Jordan, but LeBron is LeBron in his own right. You know, no, Kobe was not Mike, but he was the closest thing we had to Mike. Yeah. So, and he got like that by how? Imitating Mike. LeBron's favorite player, who is he imitating? Mike. Who jersey he be wearing? Mike. But what Adam, see, Almighty Suspect didn't intellectually go there or just keep his sports with Adam. He could have simply said, yeah, that's true. But these are individuals that had the capabilities to do that. Everybody that fantasized about being Mike, everybody that read Mike's books, everybody that had a Jordan jersey on, wasn't dunking from no free throw line, wasn't shooting no threes, wasn't hitting from the baseline. So that example is still trash. You can only fulfill the knowledge if you have the capabilities to fulfill the knowledge. You can read as many books about dunking from the free throw line as you want. You can read a book from Vince Carter, how to touch the top of the backboard. But unless you have the capabilities to fulfill what you're reading, you will just be a knowledgeable individual about something that you cannot fulfill. So we have people who watch pimp tutorials and pimp documentaries, and I mean, man, but they just can't fulfill the game that's being conveyed in the videos. Why? Because they don't have the capabilities. They don't have the discipline. They don't have the know-how. They don't have those natural capabilities that only God can bless you with. They don't have it. If you listen to them verbally, they can say it, but physically they can never fulfill it because it's not in them to fulfill it.
So everybody starts somewhere, and I feel like y'all are hating on that because not even the race thing, because I feel like we're all the same, no matter what color we are, but I feel like it's because of my age.
That's a lie, Kelby. We not the same. In the lifestyle of pimping and hoeing, the black man is superior. I know that you heard some, we're all created equal. That's a lie, Kelby. I'm going to be, everybody, you know, wants to sugarcoat things. Sinful will tell you, no, we're not the same, son. We're not equal. We're not equal at all. Because as a matter of fact, you're not even going to go through the things that the black man going to go through. You can catch the same case that the black man catch, and they'll still go easy on you because of the color of your skin. They gonna put that black man all the way under the prison, under another prison. So no, I still can't go, Kelvin. Even in the law, even in that circumstance, you still wouldn't be equal. You know what I'm saying? So no, I can't go with that. If I lose some white fans tonight, and oh my God, sins of racist. No, I love white people. I love all of you. But I'm never going to put my love for you above my love for this game. And the truth of this game, the black man is the alpha and omega, you know what I mean, in this pimping. You guys are tricks. You guys are clients. You're not giants in the game. It's simply put, simplicity.
Because of how new I was to the game, that y'all just attacked me for
it. That has nothing to do with that. I don't feel like you're new to shit.
That's not what it seemed like.
You hate white people. No. I feel like you're not new to shit. I just feel like you're an impersonator for your SoundCloud career. You're not new to shit, nigga.
But, bro, I don't even focus on music.
You came up in here talking about
the streets. I focus on getting money.
You came in here talking about you professing old school, and then you was like, we actually where you learned this shit from, and then you said, yeah, I watched Short Boy on YouTube. Like,
yeah.
Get the fuck out of here, nigga.
Old school guys. I have no mentors in real life.
Watch on YouTube and in person.
I didn't have no mentors in real life. I can hear the scripture says, in a multitude of counsel, there is safety. I can hear another scripture says, without vision, the people perish. Another scripture says, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. In other words, people in the game are being destroyed for lack of game. He don't have no mentors. He don't have no counselors. He never had a man exemplify what a man is. Why you think Kelby, the moment that he heard different men like, Kelby, it didn't matter whether you got your ass beat or not. You had to stand up for yourself. You can't be allowing some guy to just be calling you bitches and putting you in incestuous behavior and, you know what I mean, disrespecting you in front of the whole goddamn world. You know, you're not no pimp, but you still got a dick and balls between your motherfucking legs. How could you allow something like this to be said to you? And then you presiding over a woman, you know what I mean, and you're supposed to be her protector, and you sitting over there allowing some dude to verbally disrespect you like this, and it's cool? You know, so he felt some type of way about that. See, Kelby letting you know that I was never laced. I was never taught. Kelby's letting you know that I'm getting on YouTube. I'm looking for a father. I don't got no big brother. I don't got no uncle. I don't got somebody that I look up to. I got some people that biologically I'm related to, but I don't have somebody that I respect that I look at and say, wow, okay. I ain't gonna do that no more. Okay, yeah, I'll do that. Wow, okay. Yeah, thank you. Appreciate that. He don't have that. And so when you don't have individuals to inform you, when you not informed, how you gonna conform to what's right if you're not informed about what's right? You can't conform to what's right. You can't perform what's right until you're informed about what's right from an informative representative. He does not have that. He's just like a lot of you guys on YouTube searching for a daddy. Oh, let me teach right now. He's just like a lot of you guys that was hurt and crying. That's like you just lost your biological father when Kevin Samuels died. Because when you seen Kevin, you know what I mean? You saw the man that you always wanted as a father or a grandfather. And then for your father, who you just met, to just die like that, you know what I mean? A lot of you are still hurt from that. A lot of you guys are still looking for a father, grandfather. You're still looking for a man to believe in. You're looking for a savior. You're looking for an individual to lead you, to preside over you. I know. And so why make Kelby feel like he's different than any other of these guys? And he's 19. He's a child. So I expect him to look at that. That's why I was looking at Shark crazy. I was like, yeah, man, you know, it was cool with the chopping, but you didn't give him no Band-Aid. You just pulled out your sword and you was just cutting on the boy and you just left him out there bleeding, but you didn't bring no Band-Aid. And as messengers of the, just as men, as leaders, especially when it comes to children, because he's a child. Yes, cut him. Yes, check him. Yes, verbally chastise him. but bring that Band-Aid. He never brought the Band-Aid. He just cut him. And then to just send the boy out there, yeah, get your bitch ass on. And then for him to give that after school program speech last night, I was like, oh man, shut up. You know what I mean? This shit lame as hell. Sharp didn't take no level of accountability last night. Just gave the lamest speech. And because, you know, he's popular right now and the girls look at him like guys look at an IG model, they just went with everything that he was saying. Well, guess what? I'm not a fan, you know, at all. So, you know what I mean? By me being my own man, you hearing a man speak his thoughts. And my thoughts is he didn't take no level of accountability last night at all. And y'all was too busy gobbling dick. Y'all was so busy having praise and worship service, you know what I mean, for the guy that you idolizing that nobody said, hey, Sharp, but you did call this boy a bitch. You did say some things to him that was unnecessary. So it's quite understandable why he was compelled, you know what I mean, to do the stupid shit that he did, you know, within, you know, yeah, why he went there. Matter of fact, I can't even say stupid shit. You know, he really was just calling himself in his mind standing up for himself. It's just that I wish he would have stood more up for himself when them punches came, but at least he stood on it. But come on, let's get to it.
And start getting money from
get
it?
In the fucking streets, nigga. And get some real experience.
Getting money.
But all these drill kids are looking at older drill rappers experience. And fucking getting influenced
really
by that, right?
Drilling, though.
But he's really outside pimping.
Nah, really.
He's not.
Really, I brought two bitches with me. I ain't never seen none of your bitches.
That don't mean shit.
He got some work on the couch.
Okay, I got to correct that. God damn, I know y'all like, damn, seeing... I know, because every 2 seconds, it's always something being said that's completely unpimpish or contrary to this game. I'm just vexed with everything that these little niggas are saying.
Older drill rappers experience. And fucking getting influenced
really
by that, right?
Drilling, though.
But he's really outside pimping.
He's not outside, number one. And number two, which is still number one, he's incapable of doing pimping. So yes, to some squares, you know, that's listening, they like, how he ain't pimping? He got a girl that's prostituting. That's exactly what it is. He has a girl that's prostituting. Do you not understand that you have tricks that got girls prostituting? Do you not understand that gangbangers got some prostitutes that's prostituting? Do you not understand that some police officers got some girls that's prostituting? Do you not understand that there's some snitches that got some girls prostituting? Do you not understand that there's some homosexuals that got some girls prostituting? It's guys from all walks of life that got some girls that's prostituting. What the fuck does that mean? It take more than that to be classified and identified as this pimping. We seen from ancient times to recent time that a bitch will sit up there, you understand me, and give a nigga the dollars that come out her behind if she like them. Bitches pay bloods and crips and niggas with big dicks and willing to hit licks, you understand me, for a motherfucker that's able to give them a fix. You know what I mean? If they, you know, if he got it. Come on, man. What's the old saying? A bitch a motherfucking give a bankroll to a motherfucker, you understand me, this is to a light pole. That don't mean nothing. Bitches sit up there and pay motherfuckers, you understand me, tricks this with good situations all the time. Come on, man. You know how many tricks in Miami is deep with some beautiful bitches, too. Ain't got a pimp bone in his body. And about to take some of this prostitute dough and go into the strip club and trick it off. And these bitches know that he about to trick it off. And what? So, come on, man. Come on. So, Adam, you know what I mean? Blessings to him. He doing this thing. But no, that's totally incorrect. Yeah, he's outside. No, he's not outside. Because if he was outside, he wouldn't even have Crystal. That's one of the biggest reasons why Kelby, he will not be coming to no tracks. It's not just fear of something happening to him. It's fear of him knowing that once Crystal sees some real pimping, shit, you know, that's he gonna be out of business. Matter of fact, as soon as he come out of, if we was outside right now and Kelby showed up to the Blade and we was all on the Blade, as soon as I see Kelby, I would walk up to Kelby and put a going out of business sign on his back. If somebody like, yeah, man, Kelby just pulled up, I would walk dead up to Kelby and put a going out of business sign on his back because he's going to get knocked the same night for Crystal. Be like, yeah, man, you know what I mean? I just knocked going out of business. Pete, going out of business? Yeah, Lil Kelby, that's what I named him. I don't like his name, so I renamed him, man. His name is going out of business. Yeah, he out of business tonight, man. You know what I mean? His little girlfriend got knocked. Yeah, going out of business, going out of business. As soon as they tell me the car that he pulled in, I would put a going out of business sign on his car, letting him know that this is the last time that he's going to see Crystal in his custody. The next time he see that bitch tomorrow, he gonna be trying to talk to that bitch. She is going to be in pocket. He's not even gonna recognize Crystal no more. Crystal gonna have her hair, feet, and nails motherfucking done. She done spent time with some real pimping. She got some pep in her step. She coming out smiling. She got the motherfucking fragrance of hoeing on. You understand? She hoeing, man, from AM to PM with a smile on her motherfucking face. She don't want to hear shit about no goddamn Kelby. Yeah, man. And Kelby going to be crying. Kelby, matter of fact, I'm here to tell you, man, if Kelby, as soon as he get knocked for Lil Crystal, man, he going to be back at his grandmama house. You know what I mean? Or doing interviews. You know what I mean? Talk about how he used to be a pimp. Meet former pimp Kelby. You know what I'm saying? He know not to come outside with this shit, man.
Nah, really? He's not. Really, I brought two bitches with me. I ain't never seen none of your bitches.
That don't mean shit.
He got some work on the couch.
None of your bitches.
Right.
None of your bitches.
Because I'm really doing this shit. What the fuck I look like bringing some bitches in here?
Really?
You're a clown, nigga. You going to get life for this shit. You going to get life for playing around, nigga. I'm really doing this shit. What the fuck do I look like bringing some prostitutes?
Yeah, the shit the squares be saying. Yeah, where your hoes at? Dumbass. The hoe is for dough. The hoe ain't for show. If you see a goofy-ass nigga all the time, I mean, one time a nigga, I ain't gonna bring this nigga up, but one time somebody gonna say, hey, why don't you let her, you know what I mean, come woo-woo-woo, you know what I mean, why you don't ever woo-woo-woo? I said, man, why the fuck would I be showing, matter of fact, if you ever see me in the picture, you know what I mean? With a bitch or some bitches. 9 out of 10, them is ex-hoes. I have never shown y'all, or if you did, it was by accident. You know what I mean? But you've never seen no active hoe. You know what I mean? That's like, if a bitch with me, I'm not about to show you who with me right now. I know everybody don't like Sinful to Pee. So a motherfucker might try to hurt the closest thing to Sinful to Pee. Who is that? A hoe. So that would be very stupid. I never understood pimps posting their family and, you know what I mean, their current hoes and shit all on Instagram. Showing their mama, showing their daughter and son and all of that, putting that all up there. I was like, man, these is not street niggas at all. We got some people that's in the game, but they just not of the game. No, Mick, I'm not about to show you who my family is. Y'all didn't even know what my mama and my grandmama looked like until they died. The fuck I'm gonna put my family all on social media for? My family is squares. They live a square ass lifestyle. I don't want this street shit getting to their square ass. Let them live their square lifestyle. The fuck? So, yeah. Hold on, let me see. And I already know who that is, but I'm gonna let you slide. You said that wasn't you, but I know that's you. You trying to hide another identity. I told you that I wasn't feeling you the day that you sit up there and actually got on the interview and said that you knocked me. Nigga, appreciate that 10, lying ass. And I'm not saying that because all of these bitches is knockable, but you, come on, man. You be on drugs and some more shit. You know who I'm talking to. You know what I mean? I ain't got to call your name. Like Pac said, you and I know what's going on. I seen you in the comment section with your no pimping ass. Come on.
here. Niggas get the book through at them for this shit.
We get money.
This nigga's a clown.
You a fucking
this nigga's
hater,
a clown in there. Person
hater.
Nigga,
you're one of
fuck
those
out of here.
Right
nigga,
there.
You're a clown.
Fucking
being nigga,
a
you're a clown. Nigga,
Sus-girl.
Fuck out of here.
Nah,
nigga, you're a bum.
Right
nigga,
listen.
See, yeah, he was. See, Kelby was ready to do the verbal. He just wasn't ready for the physical. I'm actually proud of everybody making fun of him, but man, I'm actually proud that you're speaking back. I'm actually glad that you're not just sitting there, you know what I mean, just listening to somebody just go out. You actually talking back. Hold on, we about to get into it. Come on, let's go.
Money, nigga. You ain't no nobody crack, Mr.
Every,
old School. You ain't got no
fucking
money, nigga. Pull some
money,
money out. You broke
every
ass, nigga.
Day
fuck
money,
out of here,
bro.
Nigga. You's a
my
bum.
Bitches get me money.
He said, now, Kelby, you've been talking about your pockets this and your pockets that. He said, pull some money out. You know. Now, the pimpish thing would do, of course, you know, a pimp ain't about to listen to another nigga talking about some, you know, pull some money out. And I'm like, man, you know, you get a bitch instructions, man. You don't even talk to your girlfriend like that. You're not going to talk to me. You know, that's, you know, a pimp's reply. You know what I mean? But no, that you didn't have a pimp's reply because you ain't no pimp. And so when he said that to you, Kelby, by you being in a square state of mind that you in, the reason why you didn't pull out no money, Kelby, because you know you only had $200, if that, by the grace of God in your pocket, Kelby. You sitting over there faking the whole time. See, you know what I mean? Suspect, he wanted to get on you so bad, he didn't stay there. I would have stayed there and kept eating at you. Sitting over there talking about some of your pockets. Nigga, pull that little ass shit out right now. Come on, pull out them motherfucking bus cards, nigga, that's already expired. Pull that shit out right now. Pull it out. Pull out that little hoe trap right now. Pull that little ass shit out that you bragging about. Pull that little ass shit that you ready to sit up there and be in the motherfucking penitentiary for a century over. Let's see that little ass shit. You said crystal going up. Let's see how much that bitch going up, because the bitch look like trash, so I already know how the trap about to look right now. Yeah, pull that little Chuck E. Cheese money out right now. Make me laugh. Pull that shit out right now. Pull that little baby. Pull that motherfucking applesauce out your pocket right now, boy. You know, he should have stayed there, but he kept moving. I would have kept eating at you.
Fuck out of here. This bitch is dusty
every
as fuck.
Day,
this bitch is dusty as fuck.
You ain't got
fuck.
No bitches.
And
you ain't
I,
got no
that's
fucking
cool.
bitches.
I'll say that. That's cool.
You ain't got no bitches.
Because when the police watching, I don't have no bitches. I'm a podcaster.
Let me just interrupt
and
real quick.
I'm an OnlyFans manager when the police
let,
ride.
Let me just interrupt real quick. Nigga.
That was, Kelby, don't say that no more. Yeah, man, I'm an OnlyFans manager. Oh, that shit was corny. It was corny. It was corny on both parts, because on one end, you got suspect, he's screaming, pimping. I'm screaming, pimping. But I understand that, you know, of course, that's one thing I can say. And that's one thing these dumbasses like the Ain't No Beginner and all these other stupid motherfuckers that be trying to speak on this game, right? A nigga can scream pimping all day long on the internet. He can't get locked. You ain't gonna get locked up for that. Mm-mm. You can get on the internet all day long. Just like, okay, for example, right? You got niggas that get on dinosaurs. You got motherfuckers that get on Instagram all day long and just scream pimping. But you know why them niggas ain't got to worry about getting locked up? Because they ain't doing no pimping. They ain't doing no pimping. They're not going to get locked up. You got motherfuckers that's doing 40-hour lives in a 24-hour period. But guess what? They ain't got to worry about going to no jail or no prison. Why? Because they ain't doing no pimping. They not doing no motherfucking pimping, man. Knock that shit off. Motherfuckers ain't doing no pimping, man. Knock that shit off. Nigga ain't got no hoe selling no pussy, man. You know what I mean? Nigga ain't got no hoe, man. Nigga ain't even, motherfucker can't even borrow a dollar from a bitch, let alone, man, send a bitch to go sit up there and do some goddamn hoeing, man. Stop it. So, with that being said, look, check this out. When the man sit up there, and he, watch, hold on, matter of fact, he go, yeah, he said, you know what I mean, I'm an OnlyFans, you know, manager. Kelby, get something else new to say. Because the bitch look like trash. We know you're not making no money off OnlyFans. So you can't sell us that dream. Don't say that shit no more. You know, Now, to the squares that was listening to Suspect, I know they like, man, you've been screaming pimping all throughout the video. Now you ain't got no hoes. But again, you know, motherfucker can scream pimping. You know, now there's some people that screaming pimping and they actually pimping. You know what I mean? It's like, hey, if I get caught, it is what it is. I'm able to accept the consequences that come with my actions. It is what it is. I'm pimping and what? And then you got the others, which is the majority, they screaming pimping, but they ain't got no hoe. So they ain't got to worry about nothing. Why? Because they ain't pimping. You know, they can't lock you up because you screaming pimping. No, they have to lock you up and fuck you up because you're doing some pimping. God damn it. Come on.
Hey, you, bro.
All right, hold on. People try to pull that out on Sharp and stuff too. Like, where's your bit? I'm gonna be real. Like, me and Sharp have been in the same group chat for like a couple years at this point. So I've seen some of the girls they spend time with. He definitely has some attractive women in his life. I have no idea what their relationship is, but also, you know, you got to respect it. Like, fucking, if I had like all kinds of girls, I would probably try to keep some kind of distance.
Do me a favor, get my likes up to 900. Everybody, click on that like button. We got over 1,400 people up in here. But it's only 794 likes. Don't disrespect the game. Click on that like button right now.
Professional life and bringing chicks around, all my employees and stuff. I mean, I am somebody who lives my whole fucking life on the internet, so it might be kind of different for me. But, yeah. I mean, just because he don't necessarily... I've seen some women trailing him before.
Niggas really know. Nigga, I'm on tracks. Boy, fuck out of here.
I ain't never
nigga.
Seen no bitches.
Who are you?
And I'm going to say that's true. I want to say that is true. That's true. He do be on blades. Now, I'm not going to say whether he's a pimp or not, but I will say that if you be outside and if you go to blades, if you be on blades, it's a chance that you just might see suspect. That is true. Kelby, you're not going to see Kelby, but you might end up seeing suspect. This is true. I can only say the real. Come on.
I'm Lil Kelby. Who are you? Kelby no the one pimp. Knows Kelby the motherfucker.
Kelby the clown.
You ain't
got to
know who I am,
fuck
bro.
Out of here.
Fucking Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here.
He knows who the fuck I am. I'm
you said
money
what?
Every day. I said
you
Ben said, Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
Who you calling a bitch, though?
I'm calling you a bitch.
Oh, my God. Hold on. Before we even go there. Oh, my God, Kelby, the way you called, like, Ben Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch. Oh, my God, I died. Ben Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch. Who you calling the bitch? I'm calling you. I said Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch. Who you calling the bitch? I'm calling you a bitch. Oh, shit. Oh, my God. I can't breathe. That motherfucker said, Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch. Hold on. Who you calling a bitch? I'm calling you a bitch. Oh, shit. Come on. Wait a minute. Stop it. Go back.
You.
I'm Lil Kelpie.
Who are you? No one knows
him. Kelpy the motherfucker.
Kelpy the clown. Fuck
you ain't
gotta here.
Know who I am,
fuck
bro.
Fucking
Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here. No.
He knows who the
who?
Fuck I am. I'm
you
getting
said
money
what?
Every day. I said
you
Ben Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
Who you calling a bitch,
Franklin,
though?
I'm calling you a bitch.
Look at Adam. Fucking what's wrong with you?
Don't call me no bitch.
What's wrong with you?
Crazy. I was in here chilling. Call me no bitch.
We was all trying to be in.
What's wrong with you, nigga? What's wrong with bro?
There
you go. Oh, I was taking a shot. Damn. Hold on. I gotta find
my watch. Shit. Here,
who you good? Look, hold on. No glasses. Go ahead. Boy. I didn't even try to do all that, Slim. Nigga, call me a bitch. Oh.
You is a bitch.
You is a bitch. Oh, my God. That's what I was waiting on. That's what I was waiting. Now we can finally examine the fight. Oh, my God. Let's go back. You is a bitch. What you thought about putting hands on me? That you wasn't a bitch? You still a bitch. Oh, hell no. Let's go back. Hold on. That man said, you is a bitch. You still a bitch. What you thought about putting hands on me? You wasn't a bitch no more. You still a bitch. Oh, shit. That man said, you still a bitch. Yeah, I got the uncensored version. It's on my Patreon, but I'm not going to put it on here. YouTube going to strike me and take the video away. What you want me to get a strike and not be able to go live no more to see that them little hands? Man, I'm cool on that. Now I'm getting ready to finally get on this fight. You know I'm about to talk about this fight now. But, hey man, before I get into this shit, hold on. Let me sit up. That motherfucker said, you still a bitch. That's my part. You still a bitch. What you thought about hitting me like that? You thought that you wasn't going to be a bitch no more? You still a bitch. Oh, shit. You still a bitch. Oh, no, he thought it was over. He thought he wasn't going to be no bitch no more. No, you still a bitch. Okay, listen, check it out. Oh, God. Okay, let me get it together. Okay, let me say this. First, I know everybody was jumping on Kelby and laughing at Kelby and everything like that. But let's just be real. Who expected Kelby to win the fight? Who actually thought that Kelby was going to win the fight? I never thought he was going to win the fight. And so, like I said in the last video, whether suspect beat your ass, whether shark beat your ass, or whether they jumped your ass, whatever happened, it just would have been the fact that you stood up for yourself. But you just allowed them to just verbally crucify you and call you all type of bitches and put you in incestuous activities and all of this shit right in front of the world, in front of millions of people. And so, in all honesty, I'm actually glad that he actually spoke up for himself. I can give a less fuck about them little punches that he took. I wasn't impressed like that. You niggas is little girls. You niggas is like elementary little girls or high school little girls. Happy to see a little fight. Man, that wasn't no... Them punches didn't have no weight on it. Them punches didn't have no power on it, man. Any white person, any light-skinned person that you hit in the face, they bleed easily. They bruise easily. I'm not impressed with no white person or no light-skinned person getting hit, getting bruised up or bleeding. They bruise easily. They bleed easily. And... So I wasn't impressed with this fight. You mean to tell me you stood over him and you had that many punches to the face and you didn't knock that boy out? Seemed like Almighty Suspect need to be hit in the weight room. Seemed like he need to be in the gym. Because he stood over a 19-year-old little boy, hitting him all in the face and head, and had all them shots to the face and head, and did not knock this boy out. So you thought that was embarrassing on Kelby. I thought that was embarrassing on Almighty Suspect. I'm going to keep that shit all the way 100. My narrative ain't y'all. My opinion, my views ain't y'all's. It was more embarrassing on Almighty Suspect part, if you ask me. That nigga had all of them times to hit that nigga in his face and hit him all in his head, and he didn't get knocked out not one time. Yeah, it's time to sit up there and hit the weight room, man. You couldn't even knock out a little 19-year-old puny little white boy, man. Them punches ain't got no weight on them. Them some little dainty-ass, light-skinned baby mama, them some Jada Pinkett-ass punches, man, that you had to be throwing to this kid. Because not only, and to show you that them punches didn't have no weight on them, Kelby not only ate the shit, but stood up and called him another bitch. He stood up and called him another bitch. That's how you know them punches wasn't hitting on nothing. He stood up. Them punches ain't do shit to that boy. Man, that boy stood up and called him another bitch. Come on, man. You know after your mama or your daddy whooped your ass, you were still crying. You understand me? You didn't sit up there. Well, very few of y'all was demon-possessed, but majority of you, what you do? Shut the fuck up or you kept crying? Hold on, let's go back. All of this talking about, oh my God, he got his ass whooped. If you think that's an ass whooping, you know what I mean? He got off, but come on, don't overhype the shit. He didn't even knock the boy out, man. He just, come on, man, stop it.
Clown, fuck out of here.
Know who I am,
fuck
bro.
Out of here.
Fucking Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here.
No. He knows who the fuck I am. I'm
you said
money
what?
Every day. I said, Ben Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
Who you calling a Ben Franklin?
He stood on it. That's what I'm looking at. He did not change it up. He stayed with the energy. Hold on. Hold on. What you say? Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch. He stood up on it. I'm sorry.
Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here. No.
He knows who the fuck I am. I'm
you said
money
what?
Every day. I said
you
Ben
said,
Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
Who you calling a Ben
bitch,
Franklin?
Though? I'm calling you a bitch.
Now, I got to keep it real, Kelby. I got to keep it real. Hold on. I got to keep it real on all parts. Because this dude look bad on Almighty Suspect, but Kelby, this look bad on you too. And I got to let you know why. Hold on. Y'all know I wouldn't be me if I didn't do it. Hold on. We got to keep it real. We got to keep it real on both sides. Kelby, this is, now, you stood up for yourself verbally, but the physical part, Kelby, like, you had to have known that he was coming for you, and you didn't. But before I sit up there and get on Kelby, I do got to get on Almighty Suspect, because he was like, who you calling a bitch? The moment that he did that, this is who I thought of. Hold on. This is who I thought of immediately. Hold on. I gotta take it here. Come on. Come on, Queen.
It's all right, cause it was crazy. I walked past these dudes when they passed me. One of them felt my booty, he was nasty. I turned around red, somebody was catching the rat. Then the little one said,
yeah, me bitch.
And laughed. Since he was with his boys, he tried to break fly.
I was dead in his eyes.
Who you calling me, bitch?
You gotta let him know. That nigga Almighty Suspect got his Queen Latifah on. He said, you know what I mean, little Kelpie tried to get fly. I punched him dead in his eye. Who you calling a bitch? You and I, too. Oh, shit. Oh, little Kelpie, hold on. I got to get that again. I got to get that again. Little Kelpie tried to get fly. Almighty Suspect punched him dead in his eye. Hold on.
To those who disrespect me like a dame, that's why I'm talking.
Go ahead.
One day I was walking.
Go ahead, suspect.
Right,
and it was crazy hot.
I walked past these dudes when they passed me. One of them felt my booty.
He was nasty. Come on.
Red. Somebody was catching the rat. Then the little one said,
yeah, me, bitch.
And laughed.
Go ahead.
With his voice, he tried to break fly.
I punched him dead in his eye. Shout out to Suspect, man. He had to punch him dead in his eye. But, okay, we got to get on you, Kelpie. We got to get on you, man. Yeah. All right, let's get to Kelpie, man, because Kelpie, you fucked up. Yeah, you fucked up big time, Kelpie. Hold on. Hold on. Let's get to you.
Who are you?
I'm Lil Kelpie.
Who are you? No one knows
pimp.
You.
Kelpie the motherfucker.
Kelpie the clown. Fuck
you ain't
out of here.
I don't know who I am,
fuck
bro.
Out of here.
Fucking Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here. No.
He knows who the fuck I am. I'm
you said
money
what?
Every day.
See, this is when. See, oh my God. You called him a bitch. And you seen how that man is sitting in this chair. Kelpie's so green. Like, you say that you knew, but I don't know, Kelby. I watched your video, and you said you knew that came with that. And maybe you saying it verbally in your little video, but physically, I don't know. Like, there was no preparation at all. You could just see that this man is getting ready to fly out of his chair.
Everybody knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
And then he scooted up some more. Yeah, I got it. I'm sorry. I have to listen to this now. Y'all already heard what they about to say. This is when it got sad for me. It got sad for me, and I ain't gonna lie. I was glad that you stood up for yourself, Kelby, but the moment he scooted up, this is what I heard after that.
I feel so dumb.
Kiss you. Hold on, hold on.
So dumb. I allow you to make me feel. I feel so dumb. What kind of fool am I?
Fool am I?
You so easily.
Hold on.
Who
the fuck
I am, bitch?
Yeah, what? I said, who the fuck I am, bitch? Who you calling a bitch,
though? I'm calling
you a bitch.
You made a fool of me. Tell me why.
Oh, shit. Hold on. I gotta go back.
Tell me why. You made a fool of me. You made a fool of me.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie, like, the moment when he scooted up in the chair, Kelby, it was crazy after that. I remember when I came to No Jumper with Joy. I was gonna meet Sharp. I was talking all that pimp shit. And them niggas had sat up there and shook my hand. I thought that I was gonna be a good pimping man. But oh man, now I'm back on No Jumper. I decided to stick up for myself. I found out that that wasn't good for my health. And now you got Almighty Suspect standing up in his chair. Now he putting hands on me, hitting me all in my face, all in my head, in front of millions of people. This was not what I came on here for. I thought I was gonna get a little bit of clout. I thought I was gonna get clouded up. But now all these combinations is coming from left and right. Kelby, stop. You was prepared to do the verbal back and forth, but man, when that man stood up, you know what I mean? I felt like MC Ren when he said, I could tell that you're mentally slow and that you're not ready to go. You was not ready to go, son. You was not ready to go. And the way that Adam is looking, oh God, look at the way Adam is looking. He has completely, see how Adam was laughing with you and kikiing and ha-haing with you, but as soon as shit went left, look at the way Adam is sitting over there looking at this whole thing like, man, Adam got that look on his face like, man, you on your own. You on your own, man. I can't do nothing with this. You on your own. Hold on, one more game.
Niggas really know. Nigga, I'm on tracks. Boy, fuck out of here.
I ain't never
nigga.
Seen no bitches.
Who are you?
I'm Lil Kelby. Who are you? No one knows him.
See, you thought when you had got sassy like that man. It was just going to be love. I'm going to call him a bitch. He going to call me a bitch. We just going to go back and forth. I'm like, yeah, man, I ain't never seen your girls down. Yeah, man, Ben Franklin know who I am, bitch. Hold on, what you say? Yeah, Ben Franklin know who I am, bitch. Who you calling a bitch? Man, I'm calling you a bitch. Next day, you know, chairs and shit started moving. You know, Adam that was laughing with you, he didn't turn completely white.
Seen some women trailing him before.
Niggas better. Niggas really know, it. Nigga. I'm on tracks, boy. Fuck out of here.
I ain't never
nigga.
Seen no bitches.
Who are you?
I'm Lil Kelpie. Who are you? Kelpie, no one the knows. Kelpie the motherfucker.
Kelpie the clown. Fuck
you ain't gotta
here.
Know who I am,
fuck
bro.
Out of here.
Fucking Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here. No.
He knows who the
who?
Fuck I am. I'm
you
getting money
what?
Every day. I said,
you
Ben
said,
Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
And he scooted up again, Kelpie. And see, this is why I say this is your fault, because Kelpie, how did he have enough time to scoot up in his chair and he took his headphones off? You had plenty, like, not only did you have time to prepare to do something yourself, but you had time, okay, like, okay, I'm not a fighter. I don't know how to fight, but at least I'm gonna protect my face. Kelpie, you had enough time to cover up your face and head, Kelpie. The man about to stand up and take off his headphones. Come on, man, that's way too much time. Stop it. And see, I know some niggas that, you know, like myself, niggas that's not even gangsters, but just out of fear, just out of that adrenaline that's pumping, they would have stood up and got off on Almighty just out of like, I don't know what he about to do. He scooted up. You know?
Who you calling a bitch, though? I'm calling you a bitch.
Oh, my God. He stood up, threw the headphones. Kelpie, this look is not it, Kelpie. You're still looking like, well, maybe there's hope. And then you still got that stupid-ass vape shit in your hand. Boy, you not prepared. See, this appearance right here shows that you're not ready. You're just not ready, son. This right here is the perfect thumbnail. This is like, you know what I mean, as far as like, this is the streets. This is street shit coming your way. And this is how you're looking when the problems come. This is how you're looking when the real street shit, the Urocladon comes knocking at your door. This is how you're looking, Kelpie. Like, oh my God, I can't believe that this is happening. See? Now, of course, they bring the no jumper thing up and they're gonna cover his face, but we got that part. He hasn't even connected yet, Kelpie, and your eyes are closed? Listen, I'm glad that you verbally, you know, call yourself going back and forth. But if you're going to do all of that, the least you could do is say, you know what? I done went there already. I might as well stand up and get off on him first. Or I can't fight. Let me cover up my face. I know it's coming. But instead of you protecting your face, covering up your face and head, Kelpie, you just closed your eyes? He ain't even connected yet. You can see the hand has not even touched his face. And Kelpie got a dimple and he has his eyes closed. Come on, Kelpie. He ain't even connected yet. And you got your eyes closed. Like, I know it's coming. I made it this far. It is what it is. Like, no, Kelpie. And you better thank God it was Almighty Suspect. Because what if it had been somebody that had that stank on it? What if it was somebody that had that stank on it, man? That has some weight behind them hands, Kelpie? Kelpie, you got your eyes closed. Nobody has ever, you know, sin gonna examine everything, right? You know, so we gonna be here. But no jumper, of course, they're going to put the no jumper thing on because they don't want to show him getting off on you. But we got this far. And this shows, Kelpie, that he has not even connected yet. And you already got your eyes closed, Kelpie. Do you know? Now, see, I ain't on that shit no more. But if I was on my cutthroat Dirty Mac shit back in the day, man, you would have been missing the bitch. Especially if anybody could get around that bitch, you would have been up. Be like, look, baby, see the game already showing you how he gonna be when them problems come. He got his eyes closed. How the blind gonna lead you? How the motherfucker that got his eyes closed gonna lead you? He can't even see the problems that's coming, baby. And bam, is when it hit you, you know what I mean? He couldn't even see the shit coming, baby. Because look, he got his eyes closed. You know what I'm saying? That cold game. You just sitting here with your legs open and with your motherfucking eyes closed, Kelby. Kelby. I just like, wow, what a thumbnail. I know somebody gonna use this because I ain't seen it yet. Boy, you got your eyes closed. He hasn't even connected yet, and you are just preparing to get hit with your eyes closed? Kelby, you got a lot to learn. But, okay, let's watch something else that he did. Oh, my God. He ain't even connected yet. And you just got your eyes closed like that. Kelby. Hold on. Let's watch this game. Oh, by the way, yeah, we still in that Canada. Those, y'all know why I be doing that.
I'm tired.
Because I know certain motherfuckers be watching. Sin, I thought you got deported. I thought you got kicked out of Canada. Oh, no, you know, still in this Mississauga, Canada, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we still looking over City Hall. You know what I mean? Yeah, still looking over that City Hall, man. You know, yeah. Yeah. But let's see KLB after, you know. Matter of fact, my boys used to sing a song, After the Morning After, you know. Let's see what Kelby got to say after just, you know, receiving them Jada Pinkett combinations. Come on.
Hey, what's happening, y'all? It's Lil Kelby, a.k.a. Kelby the P. Matter of fact, call me whatever you want. Just don't call me broke. Today, I'm talking to y'all.
And this is how you know them punches didn't do nothing. Look how that boy face look. Stop. Before we get into anything else. Look how his face look. Y'all sitting over there crying like, ooh, he got beat up. Oh, my God. Where? Look at this boy face. Where? What'd he do? Man, let me keep my mouth closed, man. I have motherfuckers in their feelings, man. You know what I mean? Y'all sitting over there, hype that little fight up, man. That little, man, that shit wasn't nothing. And this proves that it wasn't nothing. You don't see a goddamn thing. Kelby still look a regular goddamn fool like he usually do.
About the whole no jumper beat down situation, because I know people are going to want me to speak on this. And it's late at night. I'm tired. You know what I'm saying? I'm high. I'm ready to go to sleep. But I need to get this video.
Kelby, why did you do this? Why did you go? Why did you make this video like he was cool? Like you were, you know, I'm high. I'm ready to go to bed. You got to stop freestyle lying, Kelby. Kelby, why are you talking to us in your sexy voice? I don't like that, Kelby. Why are you making pre-recorded videos in your sexy voice, Kelby? Is this your sharp impression? You know what I mean? And, you know, I'm going to go ahead and start this video off. You know what I mean? Get to the motherfucking meat and potatoes, you know what I mean, with this shit. You know what I mean? And, you know, before I came to No Jumper, I was hanging, you know what I mean, with my little girls and everything. And I came up to him. Like, why are you talking to us in that voice, Kelpie? Why, Kelpie? Why are you in your tank top with your little boobs showing? With your 2-inch arms on the hang, showing Kelby. You know what I mean? Why are you trying to get sexy on us, Kelby? Now, I'm glad that you stood up for yourself, but Kelby, you taking this shit too far. Do me a favor, get my likes up. Let's see if we can hit 1,000 before we end this. Kelby, you doing too much. This little sexy thing that you trying to do, you gotta stop this shit. Kelby, that's how you know this ass whooping ain't done nothing for Kelby. Kelby still called that man a bitch, and he came out here with a wife beater showing off his little muscles. Kelby think he's sexy after just getting his ass beat. Kelby, like, man, I just did a million views less than 24 hours, man. Man, I'm about to put on my wife beater, man, and show y'all, man. That nigga, that motherfucker ain't done shit to my face. Look at my face. It's clear as day. Kelby sat up there and put on a wife beater and got sexy on it and tried to start talking in his sharp voice. He tried to get to the meat and potatoes. Come on.
So that, you know, so basically you guys can hear the story because y'all was requesting it. Now I want to start off by saying I ain't on no type of like net beefing, like, oh, I'm gonna do this and this and this, you know, after the fact type shit, bro. What happened is real simple. You know what I'm saying? I came onto that show with a different type of energy than I had in the first interview that I did with Sharp and Almighty. And this time I was like, you know what? They posted the last one when they was being disrespectful, so I'll match the energy this time, you know what I'm saying? Because I didn't want to match the energy.
I'm going to match the energy. Look at what he said. Match the energy. So what is he saying? I was disrespected. So because I was disrespected, that's why the new interview, I was disrespectful. So all you guys talking about, oh man, you know, you can't call a guy a bitch. You can't call a guy a bitch. Where was that energy when he was being called a bitch, when this 19-year-old little boy was sitting over there talking? And I understand he's not a pimp. He don't have a chance, but come on, man. All that bitch calling and shit, that shit wasn't necessary. It wasn't necessary at all, you know. But that's neither here. I guess, you know, it's just, and now he on here look, trying to look sexy. Boy, this shit crazy. Come on.
First one, like I said before, because I was scared they wouldn't post it, the whole thing would have been a waste of time.
I'm really trying to keep a straight face, Kelby. I know you watching. But I can't lie, like, you and this wife beater, you trying to talk in your Barry White voice. This shit is killing me, Kelby. You trying to talk sexy, you got the red hat on. You know what I mean? This is killing me. Like, yeah, the lady's about to be all on me. Like, oh my God, Kelby, I seen the way you got your ass beat. What's your IG? Like, come on, Kelby. Kelby flexing the muscles on y'all. Like, come on, man.
And this time I was like, you know what? They posted the last one when they was being disrespectful, so I'm gonna match the energy this time, you know what I'm saying? Because I didn't want to match the energy in the first one, like I said before, because I was scared they wouldn't post it. The whole thing would have been a waste of time. So I go into this one like, oh, well, the dude's still disrespecting me, so I'm gonna do the same shit right back to him. And then I got spit on and then smacked up. But I called him a bitch, and that still stands. I still think he's a bitch, but it's real simple.
I can't get mad because he said the shit while he was there. He said the shit while he was there. Yeah, you still a bitch. And he's like, yeah, I still think he a bitch. That let you know them punches, man. Them punches wasn't about nothing, man. Look at that boy face. And he's still calling that guy a bitch, man. Come on, man. Them punches ain't have no weight on it at all. Almighty suspect need to have his ass in the gym. You know what I mean? He's sitting over there throwing some widow punches, some damsel in distress punches, some Jezebel punches. He's sitting over there throwing, you understand me, some motherfucking, I forgot that little boy name. Damn, I can't think of, but he's a strange looking motherfucker. But yeah, you know what I mean? He throwing some motherfucking weak ass punches. You know what I mean? Come on, man. He throwing some baby mama ass punches around here. He was standing up over that white boy and didn't knock him out, man. Yeah, you need to be hitting the weights, man. Mm-mm. Come on, man. And he said you hit like a bitch. Hold on.
Back to me, so I'm going to do the same shit right back to him. And then I got spit on and then smacked up. But I called him a bitch, and that still stands. I still think he's a bitch. But it's real simple as to what happened, you know what I'm saying? I got beat. I said something that got me beat, you know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't really that hard to decipher or read between the lines on that, because there really is nothing. It's something you could take at face value. Like, it is exactly what it looked like. As you can see, though, you know what I'm saying? My face is good. See how my time is fine. Yeah, nah. My face is all good, though. The only reason that y'all was seeing blood is because I got braces. So when I was getting punched by those weak ass punches, and dude had a ring on too, which is the only reason that I was like bleeding there, because when my skin hit the braces, like a shit ton of blood just started squirting out because it's like all pokey in there and shit. So yeah, some blood was coming out, but nah. He hit like a bitch. I stand on what I said. I still
he hit like a bitch. Divine, I seen what you said. See, they not gonna catch it. You know, you old enough to catch it. Yeah, them Edith Bunker ass punches, man. Like, wasn't nobody tripping off that, man. Nigga could have went to sleep on them punches that suspect was throwing. Oh, you hitting me? Throwing them motherfucking love taps and shit, man. Come on.
The bitch. You know what I'm saying? And what I really wanted to speak on in regards to him, because I know y'all love the drama and the beef, but I just wonder where that energy was the multiple times he's been robbed. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever that shit happened with Swifty Blue, I don't know.
Now, I'm going to help you out. Instead of bringing up some situations you really don't know about, you know, you get your weight up too. If you're going to call yourself a pimp, which you're not, but if you're going to call yourself a man, you know what I mean? Then go ahead, man. Start working out, Kelby. Learn how to fight. You know, I don't know whether you want to take some boxing lessons or whatever that little money that you're getting, but you're going to have to learn, son. Yeah, Divine, eat a Bunker ass punches. But, you know, like, he going, come on, man. You gotta do something, Kelby. Stop bringing up all these shit. Yeah, man, where was your energy for him? You know, that just sound like something that a bitch would say after she got smacked up, you know, or a baby mama would say, yeah, why you ain't getting at your ops like that? You know what I mean? You see, you smacking me and telling me to shut up. You know what I mean? But what about, you know what I mean, the niggas across the street? What about them? What about woo? Come on, man. You know, the fact of the thing is, he still put hands on you, though. So, you know, he could do that same thing that Baby said at the Breakfast Club. I'm pulling up on you, nigga. You know what I mean? Like, why you ain't had that energy for them? Why you ain't had that energy for them? I'm pulling up on you, nigga. You know what I mean? So, yeah, after you finish naming all of them dudes, where was this energy at when you got your chain robbed? Where was all of this energy when you got smacked up? Where was this energy, you know what I mean, when they pushed you down? Where was this energy? Kelby, where was that energy when he took his headphones off? The man literally gave you, like, so many warnings. Where was your energy to cover up your face? Where was your energy to stand up? Where was your energy to fight back? Where was your energy? You talking about where your energy, nigga? Where was your energy? And this motherfucking wife beater is pissing me off. This Rambo shit that you got going on, this is pissing me off. And these tattoos are garbage, Kelby.
The specifics on that, but I know they had his chain. They took his chain. So, like, where was the energy with that, bro? Like, you picked on me because you knew that I was sitting back and relaxed and I had the mic in front of me. So you swung on me, you know?
You said the unedited version is on Worldstar. Yeah, the unedited version is on my Patreon, too. But I'm not gonna play it on YouTube. Come on, man. Like, y'all gotta be smart. You know, they gonna strike me if I play it. No, I'm cool on that. You seen what happened, so ain't no need of me playing it. And then what's the sense of playing that when we looking at the results right now? That's the results of Almighty Suspect's ass whooping. That's how people look after Almighty Suspect puts hands on his guys. After he put hands on somebody, this is how motherfuckers come back looking. After he put hands on a 19-year-old little white boy, this is how they come back looking, man. You know what I mean? This is how motherfuckers come back looking after Almighty Suspect put hands on you, man. You know what I mean? Come on, man. Knock that shit off. Y'all overhyped that fight, man. That shit don't look like... This boy, you talking about he whooped his ass. This boy come back in a wife beater talking in his sexy voice. Man, I don't want to hear nothing about no ass. That boy ain't got his ass whooping. Motherfuckers talking about, yeah, he did this and he did, man. All these little computer nerds and shit that never been into a real fight, man. Shut up.
When I called you a bitch, you didn't take it outside. None of that shit, because I would have been down for that. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I got my ass beat. Do I think it was a fair fight? Nah. Do I think I would have rocked
it? And let me say this. See... I know motherfuckers that know me from the streets. Then could talk about his L's. I could talk like that because I done gave ass whoopings out and I done had some ass whoopings. I done got jumped on, seen them been stabbed, all of that. You know what I'm saying? But it's just like when I told y'all, man, when I got jumped on in Parkway, man, them niggas beat me so bad. They beat a little ass kid like I was a grown man. But see, that's one thing in the shy. You know, when it comes to that gangbang, man, don't nobody care about you being a little boy. Don't nobody care about that shit. You know, you gonna have motherfuckers beating on you like you a grown ass man. Man, they sent me back home looking just like Martin when he got his ass beat by Tommy the Hitman Hearns, man. I came back with lumps and pancakes and shit all in my goddamn face, man. I know what an ass whooping look like. You know what I mean? Come on now. When you sitting over there crying blood, man, because them blood vessels done been busted, man. See, that's when you done got your ass whooped. You know, man, Kelby ain't never had that, man. You know what I mean? He ain't never had that. And I don't want him to have that either. Hey, do me a favor, man. Get them likes up.
Get outside, none of that shit, because I would have been down for that. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I got my ass beat. Do I think it was a fair fight? Nah. Do I think I would have rocked him if we had gone outside? Probably not, but I would have gotten more punches in. And it would have been more entertaining for sure, because during the interview, bro, that was, I mean, it was goofy. Y'all seen it. Like, yeah, I got my ass beat. Yeah, I was asking for it by calling him a bitch, but he is a bitch.
You stupid.
You know what I'm saying? And
shout out to Imagine It.
And getting his chain took kind of just proves that. And I feel like the whole reason that he went and swung on me like that and didn't take the disrespect, even though he was on camera, is because he's trying to change that narrative about himself. Everybody knows Almighty a bitch. Nobody thinks that he's, you know, the toughest gangbanging dude out there. Like, everybody knows he's a bitch. So he was like, oh, well, maybe if someone calls me a bitch and I show them that, you know, I'm about my respect and all that, and I start swinging on a mid-interview, that's going to change the narrative about me and shit. In all honesty, like, I know I got my haters. They're going to hate me regardless of how this had turned out. You know what I'm saying? I could whoop his ass and that shit.
You don't really have haters, Kelby. You know, your generation, y'all think that anytime somebody tell y'all the truth, they hating. Oh, he hating. We're not hating, Kelby. I'm not a hater of you. I'm giving you this out of love. I want you to give your life to God. I want you to stop playing with this shit. I want you to sincerely, wholeheartedly, earnestly give your life to God and leave this bullshit alone, son. I want you to totally commit and submit your ways to the will of Yahweh. That's what I want you to do. And leave this so-called street shit alone, because it's only going to lead you, son, to incarceration or the last destination called the graveyard. That's what I want. I want you to send Crystal home, and I want you to go ahead and pick up that Bible and a job application and get to work, son. That's exactly what I want you to do. You know, instead of you making YouTube videos and a wife beater with these dusty ass tattoos trying to look sexy, you know, and talking to your sexy voice. Like, nah, that ain't what I want.
I still would have my haters, but I feel like a lot of people are seeing this for what it is in terms of Almighty's a bitch. I'm not saying I would have won the fight, but he obviously picked an easy target, me being relaxed, laid back, 6 years younger than him, you know what I'm saying? Skinny, short dude and shit. And I'm not saying he's the biggest motherfucker out there, but he picked somebody a lot younger than him versus somebody who's really, like, you know what I'm saying, strapped up, gangbanging every day in the streets of L.A. where he's at. You know, they take his chain, he don't do nothing about it. It says a lot, you feel me? And, yeah, I just wanted to drop this video to give y'all a little bit of insight into the situation, but really it's not any...
Divine said don't send her home, send her to him, man. Send her to some pimping, man. Shout out to Divine.
Prevented looks. Okay, for real. Like, I went into the interview, and Adam was cool with me, and Suspect didn't like that Adam was cool with me, because Adam was on my side. He was like, well, the dude...
You that gameless and green. Adam don't give a fuck about you. You could die today. Adam will keep moving. Adam is a businessman. He laugh with y'all and everything like that. He be charming and disarming y'all. Adam don't give a fuck about you. Adam only gives a fuck that he has the content If you die right now, Adam ain't gonna do nothing but post a video in memory of Kelpie so he can get views just like Vlad do when you silly motherfuckers die. So he can get paid off of you even when you die. So when you in the grave, he can still check a bankroll with you in the grave because he still got the content. But you know, Adam was cool with me and you know, Adam was on my side. You spoke like a perfect good hoe. You spoke like a bitch that's still looking for a savior. You know what I mean? Adam was cool with me and you know what I mean? Adam was smiling and all. Adam don't give a fuck about you, Kelpie. Adam don't give a fuck even about them, but you know, they, you know, it is what it is. Adam don't give a fuck about you, man. When they look at you, they see a bankroll. You look like money, Kelpie. You look like a million views. You're an easy million views. And when you're no longer this stupid little young white kid no more that you know, that looks gullible and they can't make money off of you no more, then you'll be another old stupid white man that's sitting over there like, yeah, man, they used and abused me and, you know what I mean, trying to sell your story, and now you're getting 400 views within 2 months. Come on, Kelpie, you're being stupid.
Like, he got the bitches, you know what I'm saying? He's talking like he knows the shit. He's getting some money, you know, it's evident.
Get my likes to 1,000. We need 40 more likes to touch that 1,000. We're at 960. Let's touch that 1,000 likes before we get out of here, man. We need 40 more likes. Everybody click on the thumbs up button. Let's go.
Adam was fucking with me. And then when suspects seen that, he hated it. So he went back to that same energy he had with Sharp. You know what I'm saying? Where he's just cheerleading, calling me out for my appearance, calling me Caillou, calling me a clown, saying nobody knows me, all that shit. Like, bro, nobody got to know me for me to get money, for me to participate. You know what I'm saying? I don't participate in the game once again, but you know, for me to participate in any type of money getting activities, nobody got to know who I am. You know what I'm saying? And like I said in the interview, Ben Frank knows who I am. And that's really all that mattered to me. And
Kelpie, we seen how your bitch looks. And I'm here to tell you that Ben Frank does not know. He doesn't know you. Bank of America does not know you. Wells Fargo does not know you. Chase Bank does not know you. The money does not know you, Kelpie. Benjamin Franklin does not know. We can look at your bitch. We can look at Crystal and tell that money does not know you. We can look at this $2 wife beater that you're wearing, that you're trying to look sexy in right now. We can tell that money does not know you. Stop lying on Ben Franklin. See, you're lying again. You got this spirit of lying with you. Benjamin Franklin does not know you, son. He doesn't. You don't know him and he doesn't know you. He's never had a residence in your pocket. He never had a residence in your bank account. Stop lying on Ben Franklin. He does not know you, Kelpie. You are a stranger to him. You are a nomad that keeps Ben Franklin's name coming out your mouth. He doesn't know you, son. Stop telling lies.
Like, ain't like that. He ain't like that I was reciprocating the same energy he was giving off. He ain't like that I was making fun of his name, you know, like, oh, sus girl, you know, you sus, all that shit. He didn't like it. So I feel like I really got to him. And that's why, on top of him trying to...
Kelpie, no disrespect, but it looked like he got to you. Yeah, you said that you got to him, but the video shows that he got to you. He might didn't do a lot of damage, but no, Kelpie. From what the video shows, it shows that suspect got to you. You didn't get to him. That's another lie. Come on.
His image about himself that he decided to swing on me mid-interview. And was it goofy? Yeah. Did I, you know what I'm saying, know what was going to come when I call him a bitch? Of course, bro. Like, bitch is fighting words. You say that to somebody, you know what's coming. The only thing is, I expected it to be a little bit more, you know what I'm saying, a little bit more coordinated of a fight. I was just sitting back, and I was like, well, he's a bitch, so I'm going
to call him. No, you didn't expect anything, Kelpie. Kelpie, before he even connected to your face, Kelpie, you had your eyes closed and your dimples showing. You wasn't ready at all. Like they say, the old saying, he wasn't ready. Kelpie, you was not ready. You wasn't ready, Kelpie.
But at the same time, I wasn't really like anticipating fighting right then and there. I thought it would be more like some shit where, you know, camera turns off. He's like, y'all can go take this outside if you need to. And then we would have, you know what I'm saying, squabbled outside or whatever. But that wasn't the case. But am I mad at the situation? Of course not. You know what I'm saying? Like, do I fuck with him? No, of course not. I still think he's a bitch. Could we patch that up, maybe? I don't know about that, maybe. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah.
Can we still think he's a bitch? Kelby, like, I still think he's a bitch. Come on, Kelby.
Mad at the situation, you know? Like, I've been in some...
Kelby, you know if that man see you again, you know, talking about some, I think I got to him. He, you know, he's going to get to you. Come on.
Right, I got my ass whooped. I whooped so many asses that at the end of the day, you know...
See, these are lies, Kelby. I'm just tired of the lies. Why the lying? He said that... Kelby, did you just say the ass whoopers that you've given out... Kelby, the lies.
I don't know about that, maybe. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, I'm not mad at the situation, you know? Like, I've been in so many fights. I got my ass whooped. I whooped so many asses that at the end of the day.
Kelby, you have not been into so many fights. And you have not whooped nobody's ass. The scripture speaks of this in the book of Revelations, the 21st chapter, in the 8th verse. It says that all liars shall have their part in the lake of fire, which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Son, you don't want to go to hell for lying, Kelby. I don't want to see your soul lost in eternity in the lake of fire, son, because you had a desire to keep lying. You're going to go to hell on a scholarship for lying, Kelby. Why did you just freestyle lie like that? You just said that all of the fights that you've been in and the asses that you whoop. Kelby, you're lying. Matter of fact, Kelby, I know you're watching this right now. Lift your hands and tell God you're sorry. Right now. Right now, Kelby, wherever you are right now. Tell God that you're sorry. Say, Lord, I'm sorry for lying. I'm tired of being a liar. Lord, help me. Deliver me from lying. You have a lying tongue, son. Stop it. These lies are a vexation to my spirit, son. You just keep lying.
Just another fight. It don't matter who it's with. It don't matter if you win or lose. It's a fight. You know what I'm saying? If you don't want to fight somebody, if you don't throw those fighting words around with somebody, you got to anticipate the consequences of that. And one of those consequences could be getting your ass beat. And I knew that when I said it. So, nah, I'm not really like... you know, all angry about the situation or butthurt or nothing, you know what I'm saying? I don't got no cool scar to show off or none of that, but nah, like, what happened. I got some stuff in the works, though, with No Jumper. For sure, we all need to stay tuned with that. I'm cool with Adam, 100%.
You know, I'm cool with Adam. You know, Adam kept it cool with me. He ain't trying to get no lawsuit. You know, he ain't trying to get sued, so... you know, Adam charmed and disarmed me and gave me, you know, some good game. So I wouldn't come up on some good game off of me gaining the ass whooping on his platform. I was an invited guest, but I ended up getting invited to an ass whooping, you know, in front of millions of people. But so Adam does not, you know, get a lawsuit or anything. Adam gonna keep it cool with me and he gonna bring me on the show to get embarrassed again, you know, so I can get clouded up again. So he can keep making money. And so I can look like Boo Boo the Fool, you know, and not even get paid for this, but just get some more followers, not supporters, but followers on Instagram and a few little more subs on YouTube.
Even though I'm not a cool suspect, you know what I'm saying? I'm cool with Adam. I'm cool with a lot of the other motherfuckers that work at No Jumper and shit like that. So honestly, this is just a little bit of publicity that, good or bad, you know what I'm saying? What happened. I'm not going to look at it as good. I'm not going to look at it as bad. I'm just going to look at it as, you know what I'm saying? The results of my actions, you know, consequences or reactions, whatever you want to call it. Like, what happened. I can't change it. I don't feel the need to go out there and, you know, do anything to him. I don't feel the need to go post a bunch of net beef and shit. I'm really, only reason I'm making this video is because I know all y'all want to see this. I know all y'all looking up my name.
Only reason why you made this, Kelby, is because you just sat up there and went to the gas station and bought this little wife beater. you looked in the mirror and thought you looked sexy, and he said, you know what? I should do a video, show my shoulders, my arms, my tats. You know, it's going to be some white girls that's going to see this and think that I'm badass. Like, Kelby, way to go. You stood up for yourself. You know, no, it doesn't matter. I don't even like that guy anywhere. And what type of guy calls himself Suskerb anyway? I'm just glad you're okay. You know, maybe some white girl might feel sorry for you, might come up, you know, I don't know.
Videos to watch about the Almighty.
But you thought that you were sexy in this video.
Perspective, if they made a video on it.
Talking in sharp voice and everything.
Y'all don't want to see me drop a video on it, and that's why I'm doing this. I'm really doing it for y'all, for my fans, for my haters, for my supporters, for motherfuckers.
Kelby, you don't have any fans. Oh my God. The word of God teaches us from Genesis to Revelation, son, to not be deceived. The enemy is deceiving you into thinking that you have fans. Kelby, I'm speaking to your soul right now. You don't have any fans. Stop it. You don't have supporters or fans. You have individuals that want to keep seeing you fail. You have individuals that follow you just to see how this roller coaster ride will end. That is it.
Want to see me die for motherfuckers that want to see me shine. I'm doing it for all y'all. So yeah, I just wanted to really quickly touch on that. Like I said, you could take this one at face value. There really ain't no behind the scenes shit with this. I thought the dude was a bitch because the dude was acting like a bitch. I said that to him because that's how I felt about him. And he swung on me, you know what I'm saying? And I got a beating. You got to take a beating sometimes. But really, like, you know, like I said, what happens, happens. You can't be mad at a situation that you knew you was getting yourself into, that you got yourself into. You just got to take the consequences and move on. And that's really what I'm doing. Like I said, I'm not within that beefing. I'm just trying to keep going. I'm trying to be cool with No Jumper. I'm trying to continue working with them as well as other podcasts out there.
Oh, Lord.
I'm trying to just really make that legal internet money because, once again, the streets do not love nobody. You know what I'm saying? You cannot last in this shit forever, so.
Listen, spare us the after-school program speech, Kelby, because you're not even taking heed, you know what I mean, to the speech yourself, Kelby. But, you know, for the prayer warriors, for the individuals that have authentic prayer relationships with God, as the Spirit of God leads you, please call out Kenneth's name, you know, in prayer. You know, Kenneth, call his name out in prayer. But, you know, before we go, Kelby, I just want to take out, these people don't even matter. I don't even see these almost 1,400 individuals that's listening right now, Kelby. Right now, I just want to say this to you. You know, Kelby, you're 19 years old, Kelby. And you might be saying to yourself, you know, I just got, you know, into a situation. What am I to do? And I'm here to tell you that, Kelby, give your life to God. God did not wake you up this morning to get on YouTube, to get your ass beat. He didn't call you to sit up there and be going back and forth, you know what I mean, with some dude named Suspect. You know, you need to give your life to God, son. You know, you got this girl, she looking like a smoker. She looks like a model for Crystal Meth Magazine. You know, you need to give your life to God. Kelby, no matter where you are right now, lift your hands right now and say, Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for acting like I'm a pimp. I'm sorry for telling that I got raided. I'm sorry for all of these lies that I've told. I'm sorry for lying on my mama. I'm sorry for lying and I'm just tired of being fake. I'm tired of being somebody that I'm not. Lord, come into my life. I'm tired of wearing cheap little wife beaters and looking a fool. I'm tired of this. I'm tired of vaping, you know what I mean, like I'm some thought. Lord, I need you to come into my life. I'm just tired. So right now, Kelby, wherever you are right now, lift your hands right now and say, Lord, come into my life. Deliver me, Lord. Lord, I got a habit. I got some habits that's demonic. I got some habits that I need to be delivered from. I need to stop getting on the internet talking crazy. Lord, I just need to be quiet and just read your word and just go ahead and get a job. You know what I mean? That's what I need to do. I need to stop acting like I'm the man and let you teach me, Lord, on how to be a man. Help me, Lord. Teach me how to be saved. Teach me how to be a man. Look, Kelby, you even said it in the video that you never had no mentors. And we see that. And right now, He's able to bless you with that if you sincerely ask for that right now. God will give you mentors. He will put men of God in your life to teach you and exemplify what a man is, Kelby. You don't have to keep going to Sharp and different individuals looking for a savior only for them to manipulate and accumulate off of you, Kelby, like you some hoe. You know what I mean? So right now, just say, Lord, come into my life. Receive me, deliver me, save me, and keep me free. In the name of your son, Yaharashai. Amen. All right, Kelby, come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, Kelby, come on, come on. That's right, that's right, that's right. That's right. Y'all laughing, but man, this is true. Kelby needs to stop this foolishness, man. You know, hey, now do me a favor, y'all. When I end this video, I'm going to put the link to my Patreon in the comment section. Man, y'all come to the Patreon, man. There's an innumerable amount of videos on there that's full of game, full of inspiration, full of enlightenment. You know what I mean? Full of information to help you get your development in life. Full of, you know, entertainment as well. As a matter of fact, since I'm up, you know what I mean? I might even put something up from the theaters. Y'all see, I put that Wakanda up there. I'd hurry up and took it down. See, now I know what to do. Whenever I put something up from the theaters, now I just let it stay up for a little bit, and then I'm end up snatching it down, you know? And not let it stay up and linger too long. But I'm actually about to, after I even end this, I might put something up from the theaters up for a little bit, because I'm up, man. Let me say this to y'all, too. Hey, YouTube is on some goofy shit right now. So you notice when you go to certain people on YouTube's channels, they got the pre-recorded videos showing, and they don't have the live videos showing. So if you want to see any of my live videos, what you do is when you put Sinful to Pete in, you click on live. You're going to see home. You're going to see videos. You're going to see, you know, community and all of that stuff there. But you want to click on the live section to find the videos that you're endeavoring to find, you know? So, yeah, you can do that. And also, man, follow me on Instagram. My Instagram page is SINFULTHEP773. And my other Instagram account is the Museum of Game. That's Sinful the Pimp page. That's not my page. As you know, I told y'all that's Keisha from False Alert. That's his page. You know, he's using my name to basically stir up bullshit. And you know, that's what he does. And I'm, you know, not even going to waste time speaking on him. He's like that. And he's pretty much, you know, going to die like that. It is what it is. But yeah, man, y'all follow me on Sinful to P 773 and my other page, The Museum of Game. But all right, man, it's been a blessing, man. Kick it with y'all, man. Y'all kicked it with me for damn near 3 hours, man. I hope y'all live as long as you want and never want as long as you live. Make sure you hit the thumbs up button and make sure you click on the subscribe button and the bell so you can get all the notifications whenever I go live. All right, y'all be blessed, man. We out of here. Appreciate y'all for showing up. We gone.